So, but Moose is just an amazing creature.
Right now in Wake Up with Al, Hurricane Joaquin moving out to sea, but the danger not over yet. A different storm system is attacking the U.S. coastline.
Our message to everybody in the Commonwealth is be prepared. This one is definitely going to hit us.
Five states under a state of emergency.
Residents evacuating Barrier Island, sandbags being filled for what forecasts are calling biblical amounts of rainfall. We're going to break down the timing, track, and possible impacts right here, right now on Wake Up with Al.
Live from New York and the heart of Rockefeller Center, it's Wake Up with Al Roker and Stephanie Abrams.
Good morning, everybody. Friday, October 2nd, 2015. Welcome to our final edition of Wake Up with Al.
We're taking our final bow here after 6 years.
It's been a good 6 years, but we got a ton of weather to talk about.
That we do. So we want to get right to it here. We are heading into your weekend. Heavy rainfall and flooding danger stretching from the Georgia coast all the way into New England.
And we're also tracking the very latest on Hurricane Joaquin battering the Bahamas as a Category 4 storm, unleashing high winds, sending water surging into homes. Thankfully, so far, no reports of any deaths.
In the nearby Turks and Caicos Islands, airports, schools, and government offices are closed. And closer to home, preparations are underway up and down the East Coast for torrential rain and also some significant erosion.
That's right. People who live on barrier islands have been urged to evacuate. There have been some mandatory evacuations. Emergency officials urge people stockpiling bottled water and ready-to-eat meals.
All right. The 5 a.m. advisory just out. So let's head to Jen Carfagna, who has been tracking this, and find out exactly what it says. Good morning, Jen.
Hey, good morning, guys. We've got some big weather stories today, of course, leading with Joaquin in the tropics, and it's been battering the Bahamas, specifically the central Bahamas, for the last 24 hours. Now, winds at 130 miles per hour. It is still a Category 4 hurricane, significant for the month of October for the Bahamas. Haven't seen one in quite some time for the central Bahamas. Pressure 935. A lot of significant things out of this advisory in terms of the movement to the northwest. So that turn is what we are going to be watching today, that turn. Now moving to the northwest, expecting more of a turn to the north and then eventually to the northeast. I want to show you the track in a moment, but a quick look at the hurricane warnings and watches. Those have remained unchanged. We are still looking at significant impacts in the central Bahamas. Big rain. You see those bright colors out there. We're expecting some torrential rain continuing today, maybe on the order of more than 2 feet. The winds up significantly as well. And of course, the surge, another issue. It hasn't been moving. It's been battering those central Bahama islands. Now, look at this path. This is important, guys, as we keep it offshore of the U.S. We continue to move it out to sea. We'll talk more about what into this path coming up. But the other big story is the fact that we've got a lot of rain across portions of the eastern U.S. associated with that big trough that we've been talking so much about, guys.
That's right. Absolutely, Jen. Here's what we know so far. In South Carolina, school districts for Charleston County and Berkeley County, they've canceled all classes for all of their schools. Emergency management teams in North Carolina have extra equipment and crews on standby in the Outer Banks.
In Virginia, the U.S. Navy is sending ships stationed in the Hampton Roads area out to sea. And in Portsmouth and Norfolk, they're already declaring states of emergency to allow help from the Commonwealth.
That's right. So let's get and take a look at what's going on with this flooding now.
Okay, so Jen mentioned we do have this big upper level low. That's giving us energy. We're also getting some moisture that's being tossed in from Joaquin. And so you got the lift and you got that tropical moisture, and that's what's going to give us a heavy rain. Right now it's into eastern North Carolina here, also into portions of Virginia and South Carolina. As we move northbound, we're also seeing some of that rain. Someone was asking me on Twitter this morning, you know, they had PTSD from Sandy. I said, listen, this is not going to be a Sandy in the Northeast, but we are already starting to see the waves kick up and we're going to see some erosion. So here's a look at our available moisture in the atmosphere. So we have our big low pressure, and then look at all the moisture from Joaquin that is spreading to the west and also northbound as well, and that's going to continue as we head over the next couple of days. So moisture and lift, therefore you're going to get the storms. It seems as if South Carolina is where we are going to see the worst of the flooding as we head over the next several days, perhaps 8 inches up to 12 inches of rain in some locations here, and you can see Joaquin is still well offshore. All right. So it's pretty remarkable that it can be that far offshore and still toss the rain out. There it is for us, 12 to 18 inches in several locations.
I mean, this could be life threatening. So people really need to pay attention. And the fact of the matter is, even if we're not going to have landfall, we're still going to have a lot of effects going on up and down the eastern seaboard. So here you go. You've got, here's the low pressure, here's the high pressure. People started bandying about the phrase you hear yesterday, the Rex block.
No, I haven't heard that.
Oh, yeah. People are talking about the Rex block. Again, that high pressure, low pressure combo. You got that tight pressure gradient, and then that upper low can't move, and so everything sits there and it just rains. So here's what we're looking at. Look at these wind gusts up to 36 miles per hour right now in Ocean City, 38 in Virginia Beach, 9 mile per hour winds in Cape Hatteras, 16 mile per hour winds in Wilmington. And as we put everything into motion, you can see during the afternoon they stay pretty strong, especially up to the north, Atlantic City, New York City, Virginia Beach, and on into Cape Hatteras. So you're going to have significant beach erosion, you're going to have rip currents, you're going to have a lot of high seas. And look at the buoys there right now, 13 feet offshore, 8.2 feet. So we're looking at a lot of activity that's going to be along the shorelines.
That it is. Coming up now, we're going to talk about the preparation underway after your look on the 8s.
This program brought to you by Ameriprise Financial. When you have the right financial advisor, life can be brilliant.
I've been a poor man and I've been a king. I've had my life and the world on a string. I've traveled many roads, but I'm so far from done. Good to know there's so much to live for.
A gentleman is never defined by just one look. Get more looks for less at the Joseph A. Bank Buy More, Save More event. Buy one item, save 50%. Two items, save 60%. And three items, save 65%. Only at Joseph A. Bank.
When cigarette cravings hit, all I can think about is getting relief.
Only Nicorette Mini has a patented fast-dissolving formula. It starts to relieve sudden cravings fast.
I never know when I'll need relief. That's why I only choose Nicorette Mini.
Andrew. Rita. Sandy. Meet Chris. Jackie. Joe. Minor damage or major disaster. When you need us most, we're there. State Farm. We're a force of nature, too.
If you have moderate to severe plaque psoriasis, isn't it time to let the real you shine through? Introducing Otezla, apremilast. Otezla is not an injection or a cream. It's a pill that treats plaque psoriasis differently. Some people who took Otezla saw 75% clearer skin after 4 months. And Otezla's prescribing information has no requirement for routine lab monitoring. Don't take Otezla if you are allergic to any of its ingredients. Otezla may increase the risk of depression. Tell your doctor if you have a history of depression or suicidal thoughts, or if these feelings develop. Some people taking Otezla reported weight loss. Your doctor should monitor your weight and may stop treatment. Side effects may include diarrhea, nausea, upper respiratory tract infection, and headache. Tell your doctor about all the medicines you take and if you're pregnant or planning to be. Ask your doctor about Otezla today. Otezla. Show more of you.
I try hard to get a great shape. This I can do easily.
New Benefiber Healthy Shape helps curb cravings. It's a clear, taste-free daily supplement that's clinically proven to help keep me fuller longer. New Benefiber Healthy Shape. This I can do.
We're geeking out on what's happening in weather, how it happens, and why it's so freaking cool.
Weather Underground, weeknights at 6 on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Today, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 88. Chance of rain 40%. tonight, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 72. Saturday, intervals of clouds and sunshine. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 88. Here's our 7-day outlook.
People have made Blindspot Fall's number one new show. Monday, experience the breakout hit.
Who did this to me?
With the clue that could uncover her identity.
We had your DNA tested.
You have the results?
Yes.
New Blindspot, Monday after The Voice on NBC. And get the NBC app.
Tourists visiting North Carolina National Seashore are packing up and heading out as Hurricane Joaquin approaches. People loaded up their campers at Cape Lookout on Harkers Island.
The National Park Service closing the area to all visitors, including those staying in cabins. Right now, ferries are only running from the island.
Now, North Carolina Governor Pat McCrory held a news conference yesterday about his concerns about the weekend weather with high winds and the threat of even more flooding.
This is not just possible hurricane-related flooding. This could be a 1-2 punch that promises to bring a lot of rain. My major concern is that this storm could be like Hurricane Floyd, and we all know that that caused devastating impact on our state.
Well, joining us now from Kitty Hawk Live, NBC's Gray Jay. One of the great parts about doing this program was the association with NBC News,
yeah.
And in particular you, Jay Gray, because you have brought a lot of great stories to us and helped us out a lot over the last 6 years.
And a lot of great humor and outfits, by the way, skin-tight outfits, which we appreciated.
Stephanie, Al, good morning. It is great. I'm so glad that I got the opportunity to talk to you guys this morning on the way out. And what a pleasure it's been working with both of you. And we'll continue to work. I'm glad that we'll continue to talk to each other. Let's talk a little bit about what's going on here right now. The major concern in Kitty Hawk is that flooding, as we've been talking about. Just because the path of this storm isn't headed for this area doesn't mean they're not going to see significant problems here. And they are. They've been seeing rain over the last several days here. They've already had some minimal flooding. They're really concerned that they're going to see some heavy flooding over the next several days. As this system brushes the area, provides more rain on top of what they already have here, what they're already dealing with at this point. And so preparations are underway. A lot of the stores have been hit. People making sure they have water, making sure they have food, making sure they're ready for a potential power outage here, and making sure that they have everything so they don't have to get out in these high waters. That's what officials are most worried about, keeping people in and out of these high waters once the rain does hit. We've seen it on and off throughout the morning. That's only going to intensify. We'll continue to watch it, guys. That's the latest from here in Kitty Hawk. Steph, back to you.
All right, Jay, we certainly appreciate that. And we want to have a look at our forecast and what we are going to be dealing with here into the Carolinas. Now, it looks like the heaviest of rain will be into South Carolina. Jim Cantore has gone to Charleston, South Carolina. We are spreading crews out. I know Reynolds Wolf is trying to get into Columbia, South Carolina. We do have flood watches anywhere from the Mid-Atlantic all the way down into Georgia. Now, we need the rain here. We do have some dry conditions, but of course, all at once is not exactly how we'd like it. So here's a look at our drought monitor. North Carolina, the upstate, we are concerned about slides going on here, especially throughout the Appalachians with all of that rain at one time. It's just going to happen in a matter of about 3 days here. So Kitty Hawk, scattered showers and thunderstorms with those temperatures in the 70s. And Al, that's the thing, like right along the coast, it's in the 70s, but you just let a little bit back to that upper level low and it's like in the 50s and 60s.
And that's just nasty. Rain and cool. All right, we're going to get back to the flood threat in just a moment. We're also tracking some cool temperatures. Good morning, D.C. You got a cool rainy day ahead. Highs sliding into the lower 50s today. That's about 20 degrees below average for this time of year, and the cooler temps are just going to be hanging around for a while. So take a look right now. 74.9, the average September temperature. This is the eighth warmest September on record, dating back to 1872. Wow. But we're starting October a little on the cool side. So today, 58 in Burlington, D.C., 20 degrees below average, a high of 55. Tomorrow, Pittsburgh, you're at 55. Worcester, Mass, 14 degrees, 47. Can you believe
that? First of all, can you imagine if it was a little bit colder and this thing was coming up the coast? We'd have, like, you know, 8 feet of snow in some places.
62 New York City on Sunday, 57 in Boston, 65 in Washington, D.C. Sunday, your average high, 73 in Washington, D.C. Look at this. 55 today. We warm up closer to the average by the time we get on into Monday.
As Mike Bettis says, it's going to be brew town.
That's right. Well, meantime, Virginia's governor declaring a state of emergency ahead of torrential rains.
We are going to check in with the Office of Emergency Management. Is Virginia ready for what could be catastrophic flooding? We're going to have that after your local on the 8th.
Let's look live at the city of brotherly love. Philadelphia Freedom, that's 55 right now, and as we put the radar up, show you what's going on.
We should have some clouds. You can see them there, and look at it all streaming northbound. Now, the bulk of the rain with this thing, by the way, is going to be in the south. In the northeast, what we have to worry about here is the surf and the erosion.
That's right. We've got more. We got it all covered for you. Team coverage as we continue on the final Wake Up Without.
What do you think?
Good morning. In the
park. Attention shoppers, there's a lost couple in the men's department.
There's a great big unkhaki world out there. Explore it in a Subaru Crosstrek. Look, it's what makes a Subaru a Subaru.
Happy birthday!
Make a wish!
Very good. Okay, who wants cake?
She does. Janet, eat the cake.
Get your flu shot at Rite Aid today, because your coworkers didn't. And with every flu shot, you'll get a free cold and flu protection plan to help you all season long.
Irresistible moments deserve irresistible treats. New from Meow Mix, with real salmon, chicken, or tuna. The only treat cats ask for by name.
Hello? It's Dr. Moreno's office. Can you come in to talk about your biopsy results and bring someone with you?
Sign up for the walk and raise money so no one has to walk alone.
Very intense right now.
Oh my God.
That's blacked out.
This is so cool.
Before Mars, before space stations, before shuttles, before one small step, before rocket rides, before flat tops, freeze-dried, and flight suits, back when what went up still had to come down, we challenged ourselves to change everything. A first-person view of space awaits at the spot where our journey to the heavens began. Kennedy Space Center Visitor Complex. Always exploring.
Whoa, come here. I'm gonna try this cheese I got.
Mmm, that is really good.
Right?
Yeah. Where'd you get this?
The Publix Deli. Comes from this special creamery on an island outside the UK.
A little sharp, nutty. It's probably got a really classy name, right? Hard to pronounce.
That's crazy.
Do it. Blow
ready?
My cheese mind.
Are you ready?
Hit it. I'm ready.
Cheddar.
We went all the way to the Isle of Man to find the perfect specialty cheddar. It's the cheese upgrade you'll love, and so will everyone else. Publix, where shopping is a pleasure.
$19.99.
Joaquin, in an already saturated East Coast. We're timing out the rain, the track, and the city's most at risk starting at 5 a.m. on AMHQ Weekend and Weekend Recharge.
Stay tuned for your local on the 8, brought to you by Valero.
We've worked pretty hard to become the world's largest independent refiner and to be America's third largest producer of renewable fuels. But we've also worked hard to be named one of Fortune's most admired companies by giving over 125,000 volunteer hours a year, donating over 1 million pounds of food to local food banks, and building homes for Habitat for Humanity. To appreciate a company's true value, you have to understand the heart of its people.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under fair skies. Today, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 88. Chance of rain 40%. Tonight, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 72. Saturday, intervals of clouds and sunshine. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 88. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Past the hour. Welcome back to Wake Up with Al. Virginia's governor issuing a state of emergency, asking folks to be prepared. We've got Bill Hayden from the Virginia Office of Emergency Management on the phone with us right now. Bill, thanks for joining us. Know you got a busy day. What are you telling people to get ready for this storm?
This is going to be a significant amount of rainfall for most of the state of Virginia, so we're encouraging people to be prepared for that, to be prepared for possible flooding, possible power outages. We'll just have to see how it works out.
Do you think people are taking this seriously, or they're thinking, oh, Joaquin is offshore, it's not going to make landfall, I really don't have to worry? Because, you know, inland flooding is the number one killer, actually, when it comes to tropical systems.
We really do encourage people to take this seriously, because even though the hurricane may not be as bad as we had thought, we have a significant amount of rain and other effects from this other storm. So we are encouraging people to take this very seriously.
All right, Bill Hayden with the Virginia Office of Emergency Management, thank you so much.
All right, so let's have a look at what we are dealing with right now when it comes to the forecast of Joaquin. And a lot of people, we always look at the cone, right?
Right.
But we need to not look at the cone at all right now.
Yeah, because whatever is going to happen, we're still going to have major impacts along the eastern seaboard.
That, guys, that is spot on. I mean, it's all about the impacts, right? The cone tracks the entity itself and where the center is going to go. But, you know, in terms of impacts, there's going to be a lot of impacts across the eastern seaboard. And certainly in the Bahamas. So let's start with that, because that's where you are feeling the brunt of Joaquin. A Category 4 hurricane, winds at 130 miles per hour, the pressure at 935. The movement, this is very important, the movement now to the northwest at 3 miles per hour. It stopped either that very slow movement or that jog to the south, and now it's making a turn to the northwest and will make a turn more to the north and eventually northeast. That's very, very important. Now, another thing to look at from the satellite perspective is you'll notice that the eye isn't terribly well-defined at the moment. Your indications are that it may be going through an eyewall replacement cycle, and you see some fluctuations in intensity when that happens. Hurricane hunters are out. You got a NOAA aircraft right now that is sampling the environment around Joaquin to help out with the models. There's another Air Force aircraft that's on its way. It's over the Gulf of Mexico at the moment, but on its way to fly into Joaquin to get some new observations about those winds in the center of circulation and the pressure, too. I mean, this is tremendous. This Category 4 that we're dealing with in the Bahamas is the first Category 4 since in 149 years in the Bahamas that you've seen in October. So this is significant, certainly when it comes to records. Now, let's talk about the path and let's talk about the models. This has been big news, right? The European versus all the other models, and the European has stayed steady in terms of its projected path, keeping it offshore. The other models have now made that turn, and that's why we have this cone of uncertainty that's made the turn as well, keeping it off the coast of the U.S. Still, you know, it's close. You look at the Cape here. So expecting some windy conditions perhaps by Monday. You know, this is going to be something to still watch. You can't completely disregard it just because it's going offshore. And not to mention the impacts we're going to see onshore because we have a tropical system in the Atlantic. Now, in terms of the steering, we talk about the trough doing the steering here and whether it's a positive tilt or a negative tilt. If it was more of a negative tilt, if we had a weak or a stronger high pressure to steer it into the coast, we might have seen that turn towards the U.S. coast, but we will not, because we do have that positively tilted trough. We've got the weaker high pressure that's going to allow it to move out to sea. Upper level low, though, is still here, so we're still going to see the rain in the southeast, and we have a lot of extra moisture because of Joaquin. We're going to see that upper level low tap into that moisture, guys, and this bright red color indicates where we're getting the rain coming in. We are going to see a lot of rain across South Carolina and North Carolina in the next 3 days.
Jen, thank you. Well, we've still got historic flood dangers in the northeast and the southeast.
Yeah, South Carolina alone, they could see more than a foot of rain in just a few days. Bad news for an area already saturated.
We've got the timing for you day by day after your local on the 8s.
Introducing Ancestry DNA, a simple, affordable DNA test that lets you travel up to 1,000 years into the past and discover not just who, but where you came from. All to help answer, once and for all, what it is that makes you, you. To learn your ethnic origins, order your DNA kit now at AncestryDNA.com.
This is perfect, celebrating our anniversary with a strawberry shortcake shake.
Yeah, I got the strawberry shortcake cone. Wait, what anniversary?
Of coming here yesterday?
Our one-day anniversary.
You totally forgot.
No,
oh, my.
No, I didn't forget.
Gosh, so you didn't get me anything.
I did. No, I remembered, and I got you this.
Oh, man, what is it?
Go ahead, open it up.
Is it a watch?
No, it's not a watch.
Oh, man, you know I needed a watch.
Have your cake and drink it, too. New ice cream cake, shakes, and cones. And don't forget half-price slushes every day at happy hour. This is how you Sonic.
True luxury is not just a heated leather seat or refined chrome accents. It's the places it will take you. The Jeep Grand Cherokee, the most luxurious vehicle in its class. Get 0% APR financing on the 2015 Jeep Grand Cherokee for well-qualified buyers, plus $500 Jeep Celebration bonus cash. The most awarded, rewarding SUV ever.
When a moment turns romantic, why pause to take a pill? Or stop to find a bathroom? Cialis for daily use is approved to treat both erectile dysfunction and the urinary symptoms of BPH, like needing to go frequently, day or night. Tell your doctor about all your medical conditions and medicines and ask if your heart is healthy enough for sex. Do not take Cialis if you take nitrates for chest pain, as it may cause an unsafe drop in blood pressure. Do not drink alcohol in excess. Side effects may include headache, upset stomach, delayed backache, or muscle ache. To avoid long-term injury, get medical help right away for an erection lasting more than 4 hours. If you have any sudden decrease or loss in hearing or vision, or any symptoms of an allergic reaction, stop taking Cialis and get medical help right away. Ask your doctor about Cialis for daily use and a free 30-tablet trial.
Europe, you love a final countdown. It's what you do. If you want to save 15% or more on car insurance, you switch to Geico. It's what you do.
I take Prilosec OTC each morning for my frequent heartburn. Because you can't beat zero heartburn. Ah, the sweet taste of it.
Prilosec OTC. One pill each morning, 24 hours, zero heartburn.
What's up with this weather, huh?
Today's weather? Well, I'd get things done this morning because we've got some big changes rolling through this afternoon. Jen Delgado, let's show her where these storms are coming from.
We'll be seeing some heavy rains this afternoon, possibly causing some flooding downtown. So the kids' soccer practice, well, likely it's going to be wet one, Sam.
That should get you started on your day. So now back to you.
Back to me.
Mm-hmm.
Sam Champion on the Weather Channel. Weather precise.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under fair skies. Today, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon.
High 88.
Chance of rain 40%. Tonight, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 72. Saturday, intervals of clouds and sunshine. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible.
High 88.
Here's our 7-day outlook.
Closed captioning brought to you by Eggland's Best Eggs.
There's only one egg that just tastes better, with more vitamins and 25% less saturated fat. Only Eggland's Best. Better taste, better nutrition, better eggs.
Yeah.
29 minutes past the hour. Welcome back to Wake Up With Al.
We are keeping you ahead of Hurricane Joaquin in the Atlantic, and also what some say could be biblical flooding. Yes, 12 to 18 inches in a matter of a few days could be traumatic.
Yeah, big problems. All right, as you look at the radar right now, you can see some really heavy stuff starting to stream now into the Carolina coastline, and this is just the shape of things to come.
Yeah, because majority of that heavy rainfall is actually going to be in South Carolina, so everything's going to kind of sweep around and then sit over the Palmetto State.
All right, let's get into what we know right now. Town of North Topsail Beach or North Carolina's coast declaring a state of emergency. Also in North Carolina, price gouging laws go into effect.
Shouldn't that just be like a regular?
Yeah, it's like, well, when the weather's nice, we can gouge you.
I don't even understand. That's like ridiculous. That should just happen. Anyhow, crews in Virginia Beach checking ditches, tying down signs, removing more than 1,400 trash cans from the ocean front.
Then you looked in South Carolina, school districts for Charleston County and Berkeley County canceling all their classes for all of their schools today.
Well, this morning, Hurricane Joaquin is a Category 4, bringing heavy rain and wind to the central Bahamas and significant flooding.
Now, while there's a direct hit on the U.S., unlikely, parts of the East Coast still going to feel the effects of heavy rain, strong winds, dangerous flooding. We get more from NBC's Gabe Gutierrez. Gabe?
Steph, and now nearly all of North Carolina is under a flood watch. The surf is picking up here, and so is the wind. This is an area that is used to big storms, but this could be a 1-2 punch. An already drenched East Coast now bracing for historic rain and wind that will drag on for days. Parts of South Carolina slammed with 5 inches of rain, the fast-rising water flooding roads and submerging cars. One person killed, another rescued when this road washed away, causing a massive sinkhole. All this because of something called a Rex block, a weather pattern with a high pressure front above a low pressure front, virtually locking it in place, dumping large amounts of rain near the low pressure. The heavy surf already eroding beaches is expected to bring fierce rip currents and extreme rain.
I cannot stress enough that we are talking about the real possibility of deadly flooding.
This afternoon, about 1,000 visitors were evacuated from an island on the Outer Banks. All this erosion happened within the past week or so?
The loss of the dune happened within the last 2 weeks.
Kitty Hawk Mayor Gary Perry is used to big storms, but he's preparing for the worst.
We're just doing the best we can to manage and get ready for it, and then we'll deal with the aftermath.
North Carolina, South Carolina, Virginia, Maryland, and New Jersey, all under a state of emergency. Much of the East Coast bracing for 2 rounds of torrential rain, even if Joaquin doesn't make landfall as a hurricane. The National Guard is on alert, and local emergency management officials plan to meet here later this morning to decide whether to issue more mandatory evacuations. Stefan Al, back to you.
Gabe, we certainly appreciate you also doing so much for our show here. He's always out there helping us with the reports. So here's a look at the flood advisories. 20-plus million people under flood alerts, anywhere from the Delmarva down to Georgia and Tennessee. This is moisture, some of it streaming in from Joaquin, and we have an upper-level low here. And what that means is there's cold air aloft, and cold air wants to sink, so that causes instability. So here's Joaquin. You can see that moisture that is getting pumped in from this, and this is what's going to continue over the next several days. Now, what I want you to remember, it's not just flooding that's going to be an issue. We're going to have strong winds. And by the way, it's going to be really cold out there for a lot of you. You have to watch out for mudslides associated with this heavy rain as well. Everything streaming into Virginia, also into the Delmarva, the Mason-Dixon line. And this is going to last not just today, but through the weekend. And by the way, there's football this weekend. There's NASCAR this weekend. There's NFL, college football, both of those. And here are the rainfall totals. Again, I know majority of looks like it's streaming into Virginia right now. But when all is said and done, South Carolina, Al, is where we are going to see those highest totals.
Yeah, and look, it doesn't take that much to cause flash flooding.
Less than 2.5 inches in 3 hours.
Yeah, and there's so many soccer games for kids.
Right, all the
this
kids'
weekend.
Activities, the school activities.
Folks, so many people.
Homecoming, right? Doesn't one college have homecoming?
That's right. And look at Virginia Beach right now. Howard?
Howard University,
all right. Virginia Beach right now, look, it's still 70 degrees there.
They're lucky because if you go a little bit farther west, I mean, our temperatures are like in the 50s and 60s.
Yeah, we're anticipating coastal flooding today under high surf advisories along the beach. In fact, there are over 20 million people for coastal flood watches and warnings right now. Look at this. So this is what's going to cause all the winds, all the beach impacts. We got this low pressure down here. Here's Joaquin. Here's this big area of high pressure over Hudson Bay. Between the two, that pressure gradient, you see the lines get closer and closer? That's the pressure gradient. And so that leads to the strong winds, the beach erosion, the rip currents. It is going to be a mess. And you look at the wind gusts going on right now, Ocean City 31, 38 in Virginia Beach, 15 mile per hour sustained winds in Wilmington. And as the afternoon wears on and that gradient gets tighter, you can see those winds getting even stronger. So the rip currents, the beach erosion, the coastal flooding, going to be a big, big deal as we move on into the day today. You can see that spin all around. And you look at those wave heights, they are really going to start climbing.
Okay, so one of the reasons that we're going to see Joaquin go out to sea is because of an upper level low. Let's go to Jen Carfagno to talk more about this. Jen, and it's funny, that upper level low is now like literally chasing Joaquin out to sea, literally.
Yeah, exactly. And they do that a lot of times, right? Big troughs steer tropical systems off the coast of the U.S. We look for that. We hope for that. It is likely to happen. But you know, we don't want to write off Joaquin yet. Right now, it is still lashing the Bahamas, especially the central Bahamas. It is not too far from where it was yesterday at this time. Still right over the central Bahamas. Seen a lot of pictures of flooding in streets. Certainly the winds are causing impact here as well. Hurricane warnings and watches are still up for the Bahamas. No warnings or watches for the east coast of the U.S. I'm going to show you in a moment the projected path, and we'll see how it keeps it off the coast. You know, you look at the water vapor imagery, and you can see how contained it is right now. Look at this projected path. It's off the coast. We got to watch Bermuda. I mean, it's out here. It's right now not in the cone, but it's out here. We're going to keep an eye on Nova Scotia as well. But guys, the moisture from Joaquin is going to link in to what's happening for us in the east coast. And so heavy rain on the east coast, you know, somewhat related to Joaquin.
All right, Jen, thank you so much. Memories of Sandy fresh in their minds. New York City residents won't take this lightly.
No, some people are very concerned. We'll let you know what the issues will be in the Northeast Quadrant.
I love you.
Love you too.
One minute. Hi. We need to do this, yes.
Letting go.
I'll say a word.
It's a little easier when you've saved for college with State Farm.
What Super Poly Grip does for me is it keeps the food out. Before, those little pieces would get in between my dentures and my gum, and it was uncomfortable.
Just a few dabs is clinically proven to seal out more food particles.
Super Poly Grip is part of my life now.
Coughing, sniffling, and wishing you could stay in bed all day. When your cold is this bad, you need new Theraflu Express Max. Theraflu Express Max combines maximum strength medicines available without a prescription to fight your worst cold and flu symptoms, so you can feel better fast and get back to the job at hand. New Theraflu Express Max, the power to feel better.
I've been a poor man and I've been a king. I've had my life and the world on a string. I've traveled many roads, but I'm so far from done. Good to know there's so much to live for.
Okay, guys, go, go, go. Honey, do you have the camera?
Yes, I do.
Oh. Hi, can I help you?
Oh, I need an eyeball.
We should find something here.
Oh, that will work.
Happy to help.
Thank you.
We're happy to help make your day a little better. Walmart.
Let's get dressed for cooler weather. Let's get just what we need. Then check out one of these to make this easier to tackle and easier to afford. Then let's insulate. Because the more we bundle up here, the less we need to here. Let's do this. Get Attica insulation for $29.68 plus free machine rental with qualifying purchase. The Home Depot. More saving, more doing.
Time is running out to enjoy buy one, take one at Olive Garden. Tonight, enjoy breadsticks, salad, and your choice of irresistible entrees. Then take home another entree for tomorrow free. Buy one, take one starts at $12.99. Hurry in, offer ends Sunday at Olive Garden.
I don't know what that was.
It felt huge.
Don't move, man.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under fair skies. Today, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 88. Chance of rain 40%. Tonight, mostly cloudy skies. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 72. Saturday, sunshine and clouds mixed. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 88. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Past the hour, residents along the coast of New Jersey and New York and even Connecticut preparing for the weekend weather dangers.
Michael George from WNBC has more on what's being done ahead of the heavy rain and flood threat. Good morning.
The ferry ride back to the mainland didn't end the anxiety for Fire Island residents. Some escaped the barrier island today with whatever they could carry, but folks like Kristen Vermillier left behind homes that looked at the time like they could be in the path of Joaquin.
It's always a little nerve-wracking. The tide was super high in Atlantique. The ocean was up to the dunes. It's scary.
A short distance away at a marina in Bayshore, boat owners like Dick Greger shared the same anxiety and questions. Which way is Joaquin headed? And what's the best way to protect our boats?
We're battening down right now, and depending on what you guys tell us in the next couple of days, we're going to make a decision as do we pull the boat out or do we ride it out.
Municipal crews aren't waiting for Joaquin to choose his course. The machinery needed to battle street flooding and vehicles to rescue stranded residents are all being ready to cross Long Island. State parks officials have even begun erecting protective sand walls as high as 6 feet at Robert Moses State Park and Jones Beach.
This is not something that people should be panicking about in any case, but it is a time to prepare.
Well, New York Governor Andrew Cuomo has activated the State Emergency Operations Center so they can oversee preparations ahead of the storm. State officials say they stocked hundreds of generators, 145,000 meals ready to eat, and more than 200,000 bottles of water and sandbags.
All right. Well, now we want to go to New England under the threat of heavy rain, high coastal wind, and flooding. So this morning it could be a little bit messy.
That's right. Justin Michaels is in Scituate, Massachusetts this morning. Rain coming down already. Good morning, Justin.
I'll tell you what, Al, Stephanie, it has been a tough morning here so far. The high tide is going to be coming in at 3 o'clock this afternoon, and that's going to be the issue. They're really going to be watching that here as far as the marinas and these coastal communities on the south shore of Boston. That is the most impact here. You can see seas are pretty rough here right now. This all a result of that northeasterly wind New England has been seeing over the last couple days, and it's bringing all that moisture up from the south. At 3 o'clock this afternoon, they're expecting that high tide to come in with a 1 to 2 foot storm surge, 12 and a half foot seas coming in. They have a really big storm wall, a seawall here in Scituate, but still there could be an issue. So they're waiting to see how this is going to go this afternoon. But remember, these are hardy New Englanders. They're really not concerned about this too much. A 1 to 2 foot storm surge, it's going to cause some erosion. It's going to cause some maybe minor flooding, but they're not too concerned. And remember, this has nothing to do with Hurricane Joaquin. They're waiting for that at some point next week. Live for you this morning in Scituate, Massachusetts, I'm Justin Michaels. Al and Steph, back into you.
Yeah, and Justin, thank you so much for all that you've done for us on behalf of the entire team. All the stories that you've brought us and all the hard work standing out there in the cold and the heat and the wind and the rain, he's done it all. So thank you. And we're glad you're with us on our last show. Let's have a look at the next 7 days here. And the big story is going to be what's happening here in the East Coast, because South Carolina is going to get hammered with record-setting rain. And by the way, notice the temperatures. I was talking about this earlier, in the 60s and 50s. So not only is this going to be wet and windy, it's going to be really cold, and we're going to have wind chills. I was mentioning that yesterday. As we head into our Sunday forecast, still raining into the southeast. At this point, Joaquin is going to be moving up the coast. We do see some pink and blue starting to pop up on our map. Our temperatures rebounding as we head into our Monday, but look at the southeast. Still seeing the rain. It's going to go on and on and on. By Tuesday, things start to clear out and warm up as well. And then into our Wednesday forecast, we look back. It stays pretty quiet across the rest of the country, with the exception of what's going to be happening in the Palmetto State.
Well, look at Atlanta live this morning. You're waking up to an overcast day, strong chance of rain throughout the day.
Yes, our driving difficulty index, our DDI, shows that we are going to see a lot of rain here in the south. Atlanta, you're at 63 degrees. How about if you're doing that drive to Savannah? Well, today, not too shabby, but there it is, right along the coast, basically that 95 corridor, you know, that a lot of people take from Richmond northbound into D.C. and southbound as well.
All right, well, go weather.com/DDI for your own personal forecast. Meantime, Hurricane Joaquin, Category 4 storm, battering the Bahamas.
Up next, we're tracking where the storm is headed and the coastal impacts and the historic rainfall.
This driving difficulty index brought to you by Subaru. Love, it's what makes a Subaru a Subaru.
You're my buddy, my pal, my friend. It will be that way.
Making the most out of every mile. That's why I got a Subaru Impreza.
Love, it's what makes a Subaru a Subaru.
Freshen up your fall wardrobe with head-to-toe savings. Right now at Men's Warehouse, select suits are only $199.99. All shoes are 30% off. Plus, buy one, get one free on even more of your fall favorites. Men's Warehouse, follow your style.
Hello?
It's Dr. Moreno's office. Can you come in to talk about your biopsy results and bring someone with you?
Sign up for the walk and raise money so no one has to walk alone.
Irresistible moments deserve irresistible treats. New from Meow Mix, with real salmon, chicken, or tuna. The only treat cats ask for by name.
It was a scary sight. How often we were changing the role, it really started to add up.
So we switched to Charmin.
With more goes in every roll, Charmin Ultra Mega Roll equals mega value. Each sheet is 75% more absorbent, so you can use less with every go, which means Charmin Ultra Mega Roll lasts longer than even the leading 1,000 sheet brand.
Cha-ching!
Nothing scary about that. We all go. Why not enjoy the go with Charmin?
We're geeking out on what's happening in weather, how it happens, and why it's so freaking cool.
Weather Underground, weeknights at 6 on the Weather Channel.
Before Mars, before space stations, before shuttles, before one small step, before rocket rides, before flat tops, freeze-dried, and flight suits, back when what went up still had to come down, we challenged ourselves to change everything. A first-person view of space awaits at the spot where our journey to the heavens began. Kennedy Space Center Visitor Complex. Always exploring.
Whoa, come here. I'm gonna try this cheese I got.
Mmm, that is really good.
Right?
Yeah. Where'd you get this?
The Publix Deli. Comes from this special creamery on an island outside the UK.
A little sharp, nutty. It's probably got a really classy name, right? Hard to pronounce.
That's crazy.
Do it. Blow
ready?
My cheese mind.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Cheddar.
We went all the way to the Isle of Man to find the perfect specialty cheddar. It's the cheese upgrade you'll love, and so will everyone else. Publix, where shopping is a pleasure. .com.
Very intense right now.
Oh my God.
That's blacked out.
This is so cool.
Cool.
currently in our area, 77 degrees under fair skies. Today, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 88. Chance of rain 40%. Tonight, mostly cloudy skies. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 72. Saturday, sunshine and clouds mixed. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 88. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Just about 50 past the hour. Welcome back to Wake Up with Al. Look at this amazing shot of Hurricane Joaquin churning over the Bahamas.
This is taken by our favorite astronaut, Scott Kelly, but I want you guys to notice something. If you come look close, you see that? There's two white dots. If you look to the one that's kind of to the left, that's lightning.
Wow.
Don't typically see lightning in hurricanes because it's warm throughout the entire layer.
Yeah.
And you get lightning when you have the cold and the warm differences. So, you know, I mean, you can get it, but obviously it's just, it's rare to see that, and especially from space.
Well, let's continue our coverage with Hurricane Joaquin, of Category 4 storm. Latest models pushing it more into the ocean. And Jen Carfagno, I'm guessing there's going to be a lot of soul searching at the National Hurricane Center today.
I said all they have to do is look in the Euro. They'll find their souls there.
Maybe ends up as well, certainly with the modeling. This story when it comes to the forecast of Joaquin and the track it's going to take is, you know, the Euro has been very steadfast on keeping it out to sea and keeping it away from the U.S. coast and making that turn to the east. The other models had not. They are now making the turn, and you'll see that reflected in the track as well. But let's take a look first at just where we are. If you're just joining us, we still have a Category 4 hurricane. It is 130 mile per hour winds, pressure 935, very strong. In fact, the first Cat 4 in 149 years in October for the Bahamas, and it has been sitting over the central Bahamas for the last 24 hours. It's finally made that turn to the northwest at 3 miles per hour. You know, certainly when it comes to the environment around Joaquin and helping to figure out where it is going to go, data going into the models has helped. New data coming in from the hurricane hunters. This is a NOAA aircraft that flies over the environment around the storm to put information and data into the models. All of the National Weather Service offices east of the Mississippi have been doing extra weather balloon launches to get more data into the models to help create a better forecast. Now, here is the latest forecast in terms of the cone of uncertainty. Again, this takes where we would see the center of circulation projected to stay offshore. Here's Bermuda right here, by the way, so we're going to keep watch on things. It's not that far off the east coast. You look at Cape Cod right here. So, you know, still things to monitor when it comes to the projected path. But in terms of impacts, the impacts do go beyond this cone, right? So that's important to keep in mind as well. You know, just to show you, the US GFS, the American model, and the European model, much more similar when it comes to projected path right now. And again, that all went into that cone of uncertainty. A lot of players out there. Of course, Joaquin, a big one, and with the name, it gets the most visibility. But there's an upper level low in the southeast, and it is going to already produce rainfall in the southeast, but tapping into even more moisture from Joaquin. Look at that connection. You see it right here. These colors indicate where we have the most moisture, the highest amount of precipitable water, and there's a lot of it. South Carolina, North Carolina expecting some heavy rain and flooding, guys, in the coming days and right through the weekend.
All right. Thanks so much, Jen. Well, wet weather soaking a lot of weekend sporting events.
Yes, we're going to take a look at the games that will be most impacted after your local on the 8s.
Gentlemen prefer quality over quantity, but at Joseph A. Bank, you get both. Buy one, get three free on a huge selection of blazers, suits, and sport coats. Choose your fit, slim, traditional, or big and tall. Only at Joseph A. Bank.
Make a wish!
Who wants cake?
She does.
Get your flu shot at Rite Aid today, because your coworkers didn't.
Stanley Steamer is the first carpet cleaning service certified asthma and allergy friendly. It's our new standard of clean. Call about our $99 carpet cleaning special.
Call 1-800-STEAMER. Stanley Steamer, your certified cleaner.
Flonase Allergy Relief, the only OTC nasal spray approved to relieve nasal congestion and itchy, watery eyes. Most allergy pills only control one inflammatory substance. Flonase controls six. See the world in a whole new light. Flonase. This changes everything.
Sleep. Remember when it welcomed you like a friend? Then it became more elusive. But why? When you have insomnia, it may affect the wake neurotransmitters in your brain, disrupting your wake and sleep messages. Belsomra is a prescription medicine for adults who have trouble falling or staying asleep. Belsomra is thought to help turn down wake messages by targeting and inhibiting the action of orexin, a neurotransmitter that plays a central role in sending wake messages. Only Belsomra works this way.
Do not take Belsomra if you have narcolepsy. When taking Belsomra, don't drive or operate heavy machinery until you feel fully awake. Walking, eating, driving, or engaging in other activities while asleep without remembering it the next day have been reported. Belsomra should not be taken together with alcohol. Abnormal behaviors may include aggressiveness, confusion, agitation, or hallucinations. The temporary inability to move while falling asleep or waking up and temporary leg weakness have also been reported. In depressed patients, worsening depression, including risk of suicide, may occur. Alcohol may increase these risks. Side effects include next-day drowsiness.
Sleep. Ask your doctor about Belsomra.
I don't know what that was.
It felt huge.
Don't move, man.
Five past the hour. Good morning, Dallas. You've got nothing to complain about today, weather-wise.
Yes, skies are sunny with highs near 80 degrees. So if you're headed out to the bus stop this morning, really comfortable at 62 with a high of 78 this afternoon.
Let's go to Music City in Nashville, see how your bus stop forecast shapes up. A few morning showers, 56, and more of the same coming home with a high of 61.
Okay, how about Charlotte, North Carolina? We are going to see our temperatures on the very cool side here in the 50s with clouds. Ooh, maybe a few showers too.
And our nation's capital for the kids in and around the D.C. metro area. Showers on your way out the door. Coming home, more of the same. All right, let's head to Virginia Tech. That's the Hokies.
Hokies.
Yeah, but it's spelled H-O-O-K.
Yeah,
that would be Hokies.
It's not Hokies.
Or the Wookies.
I thought there was going to be an R in there, and I was like, this could get really bad really
Hokies
fast.
Take on the Pittsburgh Panthers tomorrow.
Yeah, and by the way, we are concerned about people driving there because they just had Blacksburg record rainfall. So 100,000 people expected for this game, but, you know, we could have some rain that would be washing this out. Every time I see Hokies now, H-O.
They're the Hokies. Okay. All right, let's go to Alabama versus Georgia.
Yeah, first of all, Alabama dropping big time with that loss to Ole Miss. They jumped up. Georgia looking good, but Alabama's still a strong team, Roker.
That's right. So. Yeah, well, I'll take your word for it. Boston versus the Blue Devils.
Yeah, so
I knew it was the Blue Devils.
You did know that one here. A little ACC matchup is going to be wet and cold for this one, but I guarantee you it's not going to stop anybody.
Okay, Florida State versus Wake Forest.
Yeah.
The Demon Deacons. I like that.
You like that one there? Well, they're taking on the Seminoles here, and we are going to see cloudy skies and some showers. And then Clemson, South Carolina. This is going to be, again, South Carolina, Al. This game could potentially, I wonder what they'll do with this, because that's where we're going to see the most of the rain here.
Yeah, that is going to be very, very interesting. Well, South Carolina, as you mentioned, already flooded. They've been saturated with rain and flooding.
Yeah.
And we got more on the way.
Okay, so we're going to track this potentially historic event. Certainly going to set some records here as we look over the next several days, and we can see a lot of images like this coming in.
You look at the radar, and boy, I mean, that is a mess. We've got Jim Cantore and Dylan Dreyer in the Carolinas. We're going to be talking with them coming up in our next hour.
You know, this is kind of deceiving because you're looking at this saying, oh, it's going to be North Carolina, it's going to be North Carolina. Oh, just wait. This is all going to rotate actually southbound into South Carolina. That's where we will see the most significant flooding.
Currently in our area, 76 degrees under fair skies. Today, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon, high 88. Chance of rain, 40%. Tonight, mostly cloudy. Saturday, sunshine and clouds mixed. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 88. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Right now in Wake Up with Al, Hurricane Joaquin moving out to sea. Danger not done yet. A different storm system attacking the U.S. coastline with torrential flooding.
5 states under a state of emergency. Residents evacuating barrier islands. Sandbags being filled for what forecasters are calling biblical amounts of rainfall.
We've got live team coverage of the timing, the track, the possible impacts. It's all right here, right now on Wake Up with Al.
Live from New York and the heart of Rockefeller Center, it's Wake Up with Al Roker and Stephanie Abrams.
Good morning, Friday, October 2nd, 2015. Last time we do the power hour of Wake Up with Al.
Ready to do this dance?
Let's do it, baby.
Let's do it. All right. We are going to talk about all the weather heading into the weekend, tracking the very latest with Hurricane Joaquin.
That's right. We got heavy rainfall, flooding danger stretching from the Georgia coast all the way up to New England.
Now, days of heavy rain have caused some serious flooding in Charleston, South Carolina. By the way, Jim Cantore will be there live throughout the morning hours. Several homes and roads were washed out by the unrelenting rain.
Number of downtown roads closed, stranding drivers because of the rising water, heavy rain, wind continuing over the next few days, bringing nearly a foot of rain in the Charleston area.
Okay, so here's what we know. North Carolina now waiving weight restrictions for trucks responding to the storm. Also in North Carolina, Mecklenburg County public schools canceling classes today.
Virginia Beach public work crews filling hundreds of sandbags with another 2,000 sandbags on standby. And in Long Island, crews are readying tree removal equipment. They're clearing drains and removing boats from marinas.
Flood danger and the heavy rain that we're going to deal with. First, we're going to start off with our airport delays here across the board. And JFK, we're seeing delays. New York, LaGuardia, Philadelphia, all seeing some delays. Also here into Reagan National, 36-minute delays. Now, what's happening is in the Northeast, we do have some clouds and a little bit of rain, but the bulk of the rain is actually going to be here into South Carolina. The last 7 days has been through the Appalachians. This is a concern because we've had 8 to 12 inches of rain in the Appalachians over the last 7 days. Then we're going to toss another potentially 5, 10, 12 inches of rain on top of that. We could see some mudslides, and then, of course, we could see some significant flooding. So believe it or not, that moisture is coming from Joaquin. So though this is not going to make landfall, it is still just tossing all of this moisture like a super soaker. This thing has just like been pumping it up for days like this, and now it's just going right into South Carolina. So let's take you hour by hour today. A little deceiving because it's like, oh, we're fine here in South Carolina. We don't really have to worry. That's not the case. As Joaquin continues to go up the coast, it'll continue to dump the rain. Upper level low giving us the oomph, and that is also enhancing all of this rainfall here. So the Palmetto State is going to be seeing some of the most significant rainfall that they've seen perhaps on record. Al, pink, I always say Pepto-Bismol is pink, and you only take that when there's something bad going on.
All right, let's get to our team coverage. Jen Carfagno tracking Joaquin and its impact on the Bahamas.
Yes, but we begin with Mike Seidel, who is in Virginia Beach, and they are seeing some pretty gusty winds. Mike, between this pressure gradient, erosion will be significant as well.
It will be. Here's the Atlantic now. High tide coming in, just beginning to turn around and come back in. High tide a little before noon on Virginia Beach. Sea foam. You can't see the wave heights. They're running about 6 to 7 feet. The buoy's offshore now. Double-digit wave heights, and they're ramping up. In fact, the buoy off Cape May, New Jersey, up to 17 feet. And here's the big issue. I'm walking up what little beach there is at low tide, and this is the erosion cut. This is about a 3.5-foot cut. There's a huge cliff, a huge drop-off as far as the eye can see because of this eroding wind. 5 days last week, this is day number two, and we're going to continue with this. Coastal flood warnings because of this elevated water. Tides running 2 to 3 feet above average at time of high tide through Saturday night. And there it is, all the way from the Jersey Shore to Morehead City, North Carolina, the Virginia Beach area, up into the Chesapeake Bay and the Outer Banks. The forecast, wind and rain will continue through Saturday, even into Sunday. Monday is when the hurricane will go north of our latitude, but well offshore, which is a good thing. But Al, again, we don't need a hurricane. You can see what it's done to the beaches last week and this week. They have lost a ton of, tons and tons of sand. Al?
Wow, you look at that erosion. That's amazing, Mike. All right, thanks so much. And we've got more coming, unfortunately. So here we go. Big area of high pressure up over Hudson Bay, Canada. You got, of course, we're looking at Joaquin there. The difference between the two, that's the pressure gradient. Those lines, the tighter the gradient, the stronger the winds, the stronger the onshore winds. And so we're going to be seeing a lot of coastal effects. The winds just being one of them, beach erosion, coastal flooding. It is going to be a mess. You look at these sustained winds all day today, into tomorrow, into Sunday, as you watch Joaquin slowly move up along the coast, but away from the coast. But again, you don't need that direct hit to see what's going to happen. We've got coastal flood advisories, coastal flood warnings up and down the eastern seaboard as we continue to track it. And you look at that wave forecast, under 10 feet, but then you get 10 to 15 feet as you get closer to shore. And as we moved on through the period, you're just going to see those waves continue to pound the coast, causing that erosion and coastal flooding.
Okay, so let's get more details on Joaquin right now. Jen Carfagno is in the expert desk. Jen.
All right, guys, let's take a look at what we have. The latest advisory, the 5 o'clock advisory, winds at 130 miles per hour, still category 4, pressure 935. Very significant strengthening happened in the past 24 hours. Also in the past 24 hours, this hasn't moved. It is still raking the central Bahamas. One thing you'll note from the latest advisory, it has made that move to the northwest. So today we do expect it to make a turn to the northwest and eventually to the north and then northeast. Still, hurricane warnings are up. Nassau is right here, by the way, just right now getting some clouds, a little bit of rain, but not really in the brunt of it. You can see right here, the brunt of it is down in the central Bahamas, Crooked Island, Long Island, all dealing with the worst of the weather, and winds have been very persistent at over, you know, in some of the islands surrounding that, over 30, 40 miles per hour. Now, let's take a look at the rainfall in the Bahamas, because I do really want to give a good update here for you in the Bahamas. We are going to see it move out later today. Look at this. By Saturday morning, it is moving away. You will see improving weather in the Bahamas. The projected path, guys, still keeps it off the coast of the U.S.
Wow. All right, Jen, thank you. One of the biggest threats this weekend, storm surge, damage it can cause.
Yes, up next, we're headed out to New Jersey, where they're making new strides in technology that can help detect water levels right after your local on the 8s.
Guapo doesn't know he's eating natural food made with real quality ingredients, no soy, wheat, or corn. All he knows is there will be no crumb left. PetSmart has a wide selection of natural foods. Right now, save up to $7 on select bags of dry dog food. PetSmart.
I've been a poor man and I've been a king. I've had my life and the world on a string. I've traveled many roads, but I'm so far from done. To know there's so much to live for.
Heartburn comes creeping up on you. Fight back with relief so smooth and fast. Tums Smoothie starts dissolving the instant it touches your tongue and neutralizes stomach acid at the source. Smoothies, only from Tums.
Coughing, sniffling, and wishing you could stay in bed all day. When your cold is this bad, you need new Theraflu Express Max. Theraflu Express Max combines maximum strength medicines available without a prescription to fight your worst cold and flu symptoms, so you can feel better fast and get back to the job at hand. New Theraflu Express Max, the power to feel better.
The best place in the galaxy for everything Star Wars. Walmart.
Andrew. Rita. Sandy. Meet Chris. Jackie. Joe. Minor damage or major disaster?
When you need us most, we're there. State Farm. We're a force of nature, too.
Here at the TD Ameritrade Trader Group, they work all the time. What's up, JJ? Working hard?
Working 24-7 on Mobile Trader, rated number one trading app in the App Store. It lets you trade stocks, options, futures, even advanced orders. And it offers more charts than a lot of the other competitors do in desktop.
You work so late. I guess you don't get to see your family very much.
I see them all the time. Did you finish your derivative pricing model, honey?
For all the confidence you need, TD Ameritrade, you got this.
Joaquin and an already saturated East Coast. We're timing out the rain, the track, and the city's most at risk starting at 5 a.m. on AMHQ Weekend and Weekend Recharge.
Currently in our area, 76 degrees under fair skies. Today, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 88. Chance of rain 40%. Tonight, mostly cloudy skies. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 72. Saturday, sunshine and clouds mixed. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 88. Here's our 7-day outlook.
What's the word on Weather Underground?
Drum roll.
The weather geeks have weighed in and
boom.
They geeking love it.
Weather Underground, my friend.
Hopefully you learned something with that.
I'm a weather geek for life.
Join in on the fun. Weather Underground, Geek Nights at 6 on the Weather Channel.
Well, tourists visiting North Carolina's National Seashore are packing up and heading out. As Hurricane Joaquin approaches, people loaded up their campers at Cape Lookout on Harker's Island.
That's right. National Park Service closing the area to all visitors, including those staying in cabins. Right now, ferries are only running from the island.
All right, so let's have a look at the latest from North Carolina. NBC's Jay Gray is live in Kitty Hawk this morning. And Jay, are people taking this seriously, or do they feel like, okay, well, Joaquin's not going to make landfall, so we're in the clear?
No, Stefan, good morning to you. They're taking it very seriously here, and I think one of the reasons why is they've seen so much rain over the last several days here. They've seen minimal flooding. They know that more rain added to that mix is going to cause some serious problems. You talked about people evacuating. Ocracoke Island also evacuating, only accessible by ferry, Al, as you were talking about, and the ferry's only going out right now. They want to make sure those folks get to higher ground when the water does begin to pick up here. We've seen minimal boarding here, some people boarding up just in case the wind is stronger than expected. But it's that water that's going to be the major issue. We've seen some flooding throughout the week here and across the Carolinas. That's only going to get worse. Joaquin expected to dump 4, maybe 5 inches in some areas. And this is a place that just can't take any more water. Saturated at this point. We've seen it spitting throughout the morning. That's only going to pick up as we move through the day and through the weekend. So a lot of people making sure they have food, they have water, that they're prepared to be without power for the next several days, and most importantly, making sure that they don't have to get out in what could be some pretty high flood waters here. We'll keep watching it. For now, though, that's the latest live here in Kitty Hawk. I'm Jay Gray. Back to you.
Jay, again, thank you so much for your 6 years of contributions and support. We could not have done it. Yeah. You helped us with so many stories.
All these people make us look good. Yeah.
Thank you so much, my friend. Really appreciate
you.
It.
Thank you, guys.
All right, we're gonna
thank you, Jay.
All the best. Well, we're going to head up the coast to New Jersey, where we're also looking at potential for flooding.
Yeah, and here it's going to be more of an erosion and choppy waves as the waves are really starting to kick up. This is in Belmar yesterday, where winds gusted 20 miles an hour, and we could see some rain here.
That's right. One of the people who helped class up this joint, and it was great having our own reporter, Reagan Medji. She's live in Seaside Heights. Your enthusiasm and your skill has really added to our program. Reagan.
Well, thank you, Al. Thank you, Steph. And I'll tell you right now, because of you guys, it is not hard to wake up so early in the morning. So I say thank you. So now we are here at Seaside Heights, New Jersey. You can see that the wind is really kicking up the waves behind me. They're really powerful at this point. The rain and the wind gusts kept me up all night, likely a lot of people throughout the New Jersey coast. This storm, not Hurricane Joaquin, but this storm is going to be causing coastal flooding and beach erosion, something that the Stevens Institute of Technology in Hoboken are monitoring. We have a website we're going to throw up on the screen. If you go to this website, stevens.edu/NIHOPS, you'll be able to see, if you live in New Jersey or the New York Harbor, the storm surge. They have these really fancy sensors where they can level, that we can watch the water levels rise and fall. Now, we're going to talk to Tom Harrington. We're going to hear from him about these sensors.
We know within a couple of millimeters the actual water elevation, which is important when we want to understand during a storm like Joaquin, where we could have flooding, how high the water may get over land. And that's really what people are most interested in.
Yeah, so those sensors are going to be located along the piers all up and down the coast of New Jersey and in the piers in the New York Harbor. They really do measure the water. Go to that website. Let's get up on the screen again. Just click on that website. Follow the storm surge. You can see in the coastal communities where that water is. Will you be flooded? And they predict 72 hours out. Very important stuff, guys. Gusts about 14 miles an hour. And I will tell you, Al and Steph, it has been an absolute honor and a pleasure to wake up with you. Back to you,
thank guys. You. Thank you, Reagan. We appreciate everything you've done. All right, let's look at the current forecast and radar. Boy, you see this stuff coming in. And as you've been saying, this is a little deceiving.
Mm-hmm. I think because right now people are saying, oh, okay, it's going to be North Carolina, Virginia. But in all reality, this is all going to kind of rotate back down to South Carolina and sit over the Palmetto State.
That's right. And so we've got flood alerts, flood watches, flash flood watches from D.C. all the way down to Augusta.
Yeah, and so this is going to last for the next several days. It's not like it's just going to be today or to tomorrow. It's going to last at least for the next 3 days. We could see over a foot of rain there into South Carolina and into Georgia too, right there on the border.
And all these areas really within flash flood guidance of getting flash flooding in the next several days. So we're going to watch that. In North Carolina, every single county there is under a flash flood warning.
We are going to talk to North Carolina's Director of Emergency Management, who's facing evacuation orders and when the worst of the rain will hit.
We always were told we were German. We were in a German dance group. I wore lederhosen, so I just started poking around on Ancestry. Then I decided to have my DNA tested through Ancestry DNA. It turns out I'm Scottish. So I traded in my lederhosen for a kilt.
Happy anniversary dinner, darling. I'm messing up every dish, pot, and plate to show my love. Ta-da. This devotion only calls for a little bit of Dawn Ultra. Now even more concentrated. Just one bottle has the grease-cleaning power of two bottles of this other liquid. You still got it, Romeo. A drop of Dawn and grease is gone.
Pureleaf believes in tea that actually tastes like tea. That's why we brew with real tea leaves. It's a little more work, but that's what you do for the love of leaves. Pure Leaf, real leaf brewed tea.
When is your flu shot more than a flu shot? When it helps give a life-saving vaccine to a child in need in a developing country. Thanks to customers like you, Walgreens Get a Shot, Give a Shot program has helped provide 7 million vaccines. Make your flu shot make a world of difference. Walgreens. At the corner of happy and healthy.
We're geeking out on what's happening in weather, how it happens, and why it's so freaking cool.
Weather Underground, weeknights at 6 on the weather.
Shiny, gorgeous hair color is simply captivating. And now you can get exquisite, easy-to-use, salon-quality color at home. Madison Reed is formulated in Italy, starting with all the things healthy hair loves, not the usual harsh ingredients. Only online. Satisfaction guaranteed. Madison Reed. Visit our website right now.
I could tell you more about boilers than I can about computers. Processing credit cards with Square has made collecting money very easy. the funds are deposited right away. I know and I can rely on having that money to be able to use for the success of the business. It's just a very simple process.
Accept all major credit cards with Square and get your money fast. Get your free card reader at square.com.
Site below.
Very intense right now.
Oh my gosh.
That's blacked out.
This is so cool.
Stay tuned for your local only eights, brought to you by Valero.
You may know us for our quality fuels. You might know we're the world's largest independent refiner, or even that we're in the Fortune 500 top 20. But did you know? We've given over $100 million for children's charities, delivered more than 45,000 Meals on Wheels, and given over $10 million for higher education. To appreciate a company's true value, you have to understand the heart of its people.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under fair skies. Today, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 88. Chance of rain 40%. Tonight, mostly cloudy skies. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 72. Saturday, sunshine and clouds mixed. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 88. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Past the hour, Atlantic Coast preparing for some serious flooding, heavy rain in North Carolina. In fact, every county in that state under a flash flood watch.
On the phone with us now is Mike Sprayberry, director of North Carolina's Emergency Management Office.
Mike, so you've issued evacuation orders for some of the barrier islands. Do you see any more mandatory evacuations going up?
We don't at this time. What we might be looking at is just local evacuations due to local flooding.
All right. So, we've had so much rain. Are you guys concerned about, especially into the higher elevations, perhaps some slides occurring?
Not so much slides right now, but I can tell you that we're looking at a significant amount of rain coming over the next 3 days. So to that end, we've got a lot of swift water rescue teams that are activated and deployed. They're moving actually to staging areas today so that they'll be able to provide a very quick and decisive response should we need to have one.
Say, Mike, with Joaquin's path offshore, are you worried that people are getting complacent and may not take proper precautions?
Well, you always have that worry, and it's been a long time since we've had a significant hit, but I can tell you that we're not going to let our guard down here, with barrier islands like we have, and we just want to make sure that we're ready. The governor has organized a strong response, and so we think that we're prepared.
All right, Mike Sprayberry from the Office of Emergency Management there in North Carolina. Thank you so much, sir, for that information.
Okay, so flooding's not going to be the only issue. We're also going to see some significant winds that's going to cause a lot of erosion. Let's go to Jen Carfagno, who has been tracking this system, and talk about the greatest threats. Jen.
All right, so yeah, the wind, the rain, the greatest threats in the U.S. East Coast. We're very concerned about the Bahamas, though. I mean, we still have a Category 4 hurricane lashing the central Bahamas, and we're seeing pictures of flooding coming out. You know, certainly we'll be looking for wind damage reports as well. Significant 130 mile per hour winds, pressure 935. The movement, though, this is very interesting. This is from the 5 o'clock advisory, the movement to the northwest now. So what we expect to happen today is a turn. It's been sitting, right, and not moving much at all. We needed to make that turn up to the north and then eventually northeast. Data coming in. So we now have an Air Force aircraft, Hurricane Hunter, coming in to get new data. So we'll get that within the next 2 hours or so. We'll get some new information about the winds within the system and in the eye wall as well. But all of this data that we've been getting from the aircraft, all of the data we've been getting from the weather balloons, and in the eastern seaboard to get extra weather balloons lately, it's all been going into the forecast and the projected path. The European model, got to give it props. It's been taking it off the coast and has done so the entire time. The other models have made that turn now as well, and that, you know, that consensus really allowed the projected path to keep it off the eastern seaboard. Just want to show you, you know, how the JFS, the American model, has made that turn along with the European. But what also is interesting is this just refers to where the center of the storm is going to be, Joaquin. We still have a lot of weather right along the eastern seaboard, and you guys talked about the winds. I mean, we're going to see the wind onshore for a couple of days. That's a big concern for coastal erosion and coastal flooding. The rainfall is going to be tremendous as well, because there is a link, a tropical link to the moisture from Joaquin getting drawn into especially South and North Carolina, and that's where we could see more than a foot of rainfall. I mean, it plays out like this. You see the rain this morning, and then getting into tonight, we've got very heavy rain still coming into the same area. You look at Charleston, one of the spots we're very concerned about for heavy rain and flooding, and it continues right into Saturday and Sunday as well. All right, guys, so that's the latest. We'll bring you more through the morning.
Jen, thank you. Well, historic flood dangers for the eastern seaboard.
Yes, in South Carolina alone, they could see over a foot of rain over the next few days. Bad news for areas already saturated. We go live to Jim Cantore in Charleston.
Happy birthday!
Make a wish!
Very good. Okay, who wants cake?
She does. Janet.
Get your flu shot at Rite Aid today, because your coworkers didn't. And with every flu shot, you'll get a free cold and flu protection plan to help you all season long.
Time is running out to enjoy buy one, take one at Olive Garden. Tonight, enjoy breadsticks, salad, and your choice of irresistible entrees. Then take home another entree for tomorrow free. Buy one, take one starts at $12.99. Hurry in, offer ends Sunday at Olive Garden.
Two most significant events of the 20th century. The Allies win the war, and this.
Ladies and gentlemen, Steve Jobs.
Your daughter and her mother are on welfare.
She's not my daughter.
You can be decent and gifted at the same time. It's not binary.
From the writer of The Social Network and the director of Slumdog Millionaire.
What you make isn't supposed to be the best part of you. You're a father. That's what's supposed to be the best part of you.
Good luck.
Steve Jobs, rated R.
Every morning, Rudy gets these new Milk-Bone Good Morning Daily Vitamin Treats. They've got nutrients that aren't in most dog foods, and I get stuck with these. Hey, why don't I get a treat? Oh, that's right. I get pancakes! Say it with Milk-Bone.
If you're the band Europe, you love a final countdown.
It's what you do.
If you want to save 15% or more on car insurance, you switch to Geico. It's what you do.
Tell you more about boilers than I can about computers. Processing credit cards with Square has made collecting money very easy. The funds are deposited right away. I know, and I can rely on having that money to be able to use for the success of the business. It's just a very simple process.
Accept all major credit cards with Square and get your money fast. Get your free card reader at square.com.
What's up with this weather, huh?
Today's weather? Well, I'd get things done this morning because we've got some big changes rolling through this afternoon. Jim Cantore has that.
Sam, this is fascinating. Rapidly rising warm, moist air creating this huge cumulonimbus cloud. Oftentimes, the results can be electrifying. Back to you, Sam.
Great job, Jim. That should get you started on your day. So now, back to you.
Back to me.
Sam Champion on the Weather Channel. Weather precise.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under fair skies. Today, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 88. Chance of rain 40%. Tonight, mostly cloudy skies. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 72. Saturday, sunshine and clouds mixed. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 88. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Closed captioning brought to you by Eggland's Best Eggs.
There's only one egg that just tastes better, with more vitamins and less saturated fat. Only Eggland's Best. Better taste, better nutrition, better eggs.
29 minutes past the hour. Welcome back to Wake Up With Al.
We are keeping a close eye on Hurricane Joaquin in the Atlantic, and a lot of heavy rain from the system is getting tossed back to the East Coast here.
All right, let's get to what we know right now. Five states declaring states of emergency: Maryland, New Jersey, North Carolina, South Carolina, and Virginia.
Cape Lookout National Seashore evacuating visitors. Also, Island Express Ferry Service stopping operations.
Crews in Charlotte are using heavy equipment to remove debris from culverts in South Carolina. School districts for Charleston County and Berkeley County canceling all classes for all of their schools today.
Okay, so let's have a look at our water vapor imagery. I always say the atmosphere is like a hamburger, right? So this is what's happening in the mid to upper levels of the atmosphere, say around the tomato layer. We live at the bottom bun, all right? So keep that in mind. So what you're looking at here is where you see the greens and the blue and the pink, that is moisture. This is obviously Joaquin. Where you see the red, that's where we have drier air. You can also pick up upper level features. Can you see this counterclockwise spin right here? This is that upper level low that we've been watching develop and is actually going to chase Joaquin as it goes up the coast. Originally, some thinking was that this upper low was going to pull Joaquin back into the Carolinas and it would make a landfall. That's not the case anymore. We think it's going to be staying offshore and this will actually chase it out to sea. So here's a look at that rain coming in. Remember, an upper level low is a cold pocket aloft, so that cold air is going to sink down right along the coast. You have the 70s, but if you go inland, the 50s and 60s. So not only is this rainy and windy, it's very cold out there, so you're gonna have to bundle up. And this is a little deceiving because you're thinking, okay, Virginia, also into North Carolina, that's where the worst of the rain is going to be. No. South Carolina, you're dry right now, but that is going to change as we head over the next several days here. We could see 12 to 18 inches of rain. Certainly could be catastrophic.
That's right. Okay, we've got live team coverage out in the bullseye of the Carolinas this morning. My Today Show colleague, NBC's Dylan Dreyer, right now, Kill Devil Hills, North Carolina. We're going to get to Dylan in just a moment. But let's go to the Can Man. Mr. Cantori, it has been an honor. It's been an honor having you on our show, helping us bring the weather for the last 6 years. You are the best, my friend.
Mm-hmm. Thanks, buddy. Always a pleasure working with you. That's for sure, Al. I remember holding on to you and Isaac, the bromance that we once had. Hopefully we'll have it again someday out there. That's for sure. Let's talk about what we got going on, though. Schools are closed here in Charleston, and you're thinking, well, why isn't Jim in the cone? Well, first of all, there is no cone, and the big story has always been all week the potential for historic flooding in the state of South Carolina, North Carolina, Eastern Tennessee, Northeast Georgia, Western Virginia, Western North Carolina. All right. We are very, very concerned about this. This is a very real event. We have high school football games tonight. We've got college football games tomorrow. People are coming to and fro these games. We could have trees coming down. We could have power lines coming down. We could have roads that could be washed out. That is the kind of rain we're talking about here, guys. And I'll tell you, just reading some of the Weather Service discussions out of Greenville, Spartanburg, Charleston as well, talking about historic flooding as well, trying to put you a little bit on edge here. All right. So what we're worried about here, obviously, we had issues in Charleston yesterday with the high tide. We're going to have them again.
the next couple of days here, okay? That's going to be a big problem. Here's the RPM showing already. Again, remember, we've loaded this area with rainfall over the last 7 to 14 days. And look at it coming in overnight tonight, just past high tide. So what we're going to watch here today, and certainly over the next couple of days, is how this rain develops and where it is in terms of the high tide. So 12:06 today here in Charleston, 12:55 in the morning, 35 in the morning, I should say, and then 1:04 as well in the afternoon. Because when the tides come up here and it's raining heavily in the city of Charleston, the water cannot get out. All right, and we are expecting 10 to 15 inches of rain. So during those times of high tide, people need to be off the roads and certainly being very, very vigilant as to what's going on near rivers, streaks, and creams. Upstate as well, huge issues in through there. Again, guys, very, very worried about this event, but we will keep you posted as it develops. Alan, step back to you. Great job, guys. It's been a pleasure working with you as well.
Thank you, Jim.
All right, let's now go to Dylan Dreyer, where, yes, flooding could be an issue, but Dylan, in the Outer Banks there, of course, erosion, which is always an issue and always proves that you don't need a landfalling hurricane to cause significant damage.
Yeah, it really is incredible considering that this area was at one point under the gun for a possible Category 2 hurricane. Now the storm is staying out to sea, but you'd never know it looking at the ocean. Now, the sun doesn't come up till a little bit after 7 o'clock, so you can't quite see it, but it's a bizarre morning here in Kill Devil Hills. We've got the sun trying to come up through the clouds. The surf is extremely rough and extremely dangerous, and the winds have been very gusty. It doesn't look like it is right now, but keep in mind the winds are coming out of the east. So they've been at my back, and every once in a while we get this gust, but since my back's towards it, it's not as bad to talk to you guys on camera. But the easterly component to the wind is going to be the issue all through the weekend because we have that tight gradient. Winds are only going to get stronger. It's going to push all of that water on shore. So from New England all the way down to Florida, we do have that coastal flood threat with advisories and warnings in effect. We even have those high wind warnings through parts of New Jersey and Delaware with gusts up near 60 miles per hour, and that's with the storm staying out to sea. So areas near Ocracoke Island had to have a mandatory evacuation yesterday. They've shut down the ferries to get everybody out of this area because at the times of high tides, that's when we're most likely to see some of the coastal flooding. Then add several inches of rain on top of that. So even though the storm's staying away, this area, especially across the Outer Banks, is under the gun. And guys, I just want to say thank you for having me on for your final show. It's been a pleasure being a part of the show sometimes for you guys, especially in the winter, although getting up at an extra half hour in the winter was not always fun, but I do it for you guys, and I'll miss you.
We're going to miss you on this show. I get to work with you every day, Dylan, and thank you, because you were supposed to be on vacation with your hubby, Brian. You busted your vacation to go cover this, so thank
he
you.
He married into this. He knows what's going on.
That's right. He happens to be a cameraman for NBC Nightly News, so works with Lester. Dylan, thank you so much. And you can see, again, look at the high pressure up over Canada, low pressure. There's Joaquin. The difference between the pressure gradients, a real mess. So there you have it. Come on over, Steph. Let's get the as we get to the final few moments of our final broadcast of Wake Up with Al.
We're going to look back at some of the fun times that we had on the show. 6 years of memories that will last a lifetime.
That's right. And I got to tell you, there are a lot of people we have to thank. And I've just been very, very proud of everything we have done on this show. Our senior producer, executive producer, Tracy Carmody, yep, has done a fantastic job. We're going to show some of the great moments that all of these people helped create.
We have all of our secret weapons behind the scenes that make us look good on the regular. We'll be back.
I love you.
Love you too.
One minute. Hi. We need to do this, yes. Good.
Hi.
Letting go.
I'll say a word.
It's a little easier when you've saved for college with State Farm.
Flonase Allergy Relief Nasal Spray outperforms the number one non-drowsy allergy pill. Most allergy pills only control one inflammatory substance. Flonase controls six. So you are greater than your allergies. Flonase. Six is greater than one. This changes everything.
The way I see it, you have two choices. The easy way or the hard way. You could choose a card that limits where you earn bonus cash back. Or you could make things easier on yourself. That's right, the Quicksilver card from Capital One. With Quicksilver, you earn unlimited 1.5% cash back on every purchase everywhere. So let's try this again.
what's in your wallet.
You can't always be there to protect her down the road. Make sure the tire she's riding on will. With the revolutionary Michelin Premier Tire, even when half-worn, it's still safe, thanks to EverGrip technology. The Michelin Premier Tire, safe when new, safe when worn.
Pureleaf believes in tea that actually tastes like tea. That's why we brew with real tea leaves. It's a little more work, but that's what you do for the love of leaves. Pureleaf, real leaf brewed tea.
Let's do this. Fall is all around. Let's put it in the yard. Add some color. Lose the cord. Let's go all out with reds, yellows, and plenty of orange. And save a bunch of green. Then sit back, settle in, and celebrate cooler weather with a much cooler yard. Let's do this. Get the power of gas with this cordless Ego blower, just $179. The Home Depot. More saving, more doing.
And why doesn't Princess Leia just let the boys rescue her?
Because she's a modern, empowered woman unfettered by the antiquated gender roles of a bygone era.
Yeah.
The best place in the galaxy for everything Star Wars, Walmart.
I try hard to get a great shape.
This I can do easily.
New Benefiber Healthy Shape helps curb cravings. It's a clear, taste-free daily supplement that's clinically proven to help keep me fuller longer. New Benefiber Healthy Shape. This I can do.
Joaquin and an already saturated East Coast. We're timing out the rain, the track, and the city's most at risk starting at 5 a.m. on AMHQ Weekend and Weekend Recharge.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under fair skies. Today, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 88. Chance of rain 40%. Tonight, mostly cloudy skies. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 72. Saturday, sunshine and clouds mixed. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 88. Here's our 7-day outlook.
In Virginia, the state's governor is urging residents to be prepared ahead of the heavy rain expected to hit the state over the next few days.
The rain and strong winds are expected to create quite a mess over the next several days.
We're going to see a significant amount of rainfall throughout the entire Commonwealth of Virginia. We will have flooding. We will see trees down. We will see power lost. Our message to everybody in the Commonwealth is be prepared. This one is definitely going to hit us.
Along the Virginia coast, 50 mile per hour winds being reported.
So we want to go to Mike Seidel, who is in Virginia Beach, who has been getting lashed by some stronger wind this morning, but not too much rain just yet, Mikey.
No, not too much. In fact, the heavier totals for the next 3 days will stay away from the tidewater. We're forecasting 1 to 3 inches, maybe some spots a little bit more. It's going to be down in South Carolina that they get the boatload of rainfall. The ocean is churned up again. We've got 6 to 8 footers here. The tide is beginning to come back in. But let me show you the visual of how much sand we have lost since we lost a lot last week with 5 days. We got about a 3.5 foot cliff here. And as the tide comes in the next couple of hours, next tide, time before noon, it'll come up here and just keep eating away at these beaches. We've got coastal flood warnings from the Jersey Shore. Take a look all the way down to Morehead City, North Carolina. That's the Outer Banks, the Maryland, Delaware coast, Ocean City, Bethany, Rehoboth. Times of high tide right on through Saturday night. Check your tide tables here. It's about noon and midnight. We'll see tides running as much as 3 feet above average. And this has nothing really to do with Joaquin. Meanwhile, it's been a pleasure. I've done hundreds of live shots for you and Steph. Al, you and Stephanie on Wake Up with Al over the past 6 years, and it has never been a burden. It's never been a situation where I didn't mind getting out of bed at 4 a.m. for you guys, and I just that's all I can say. It's been a pleasure because there have been a lot of lighter moments, most of those provided by Stephanie, and I'll always remember those, and I'm sure there'll be more in the weeks to come with Miss Abrams.
Mike, Al, you Stephanie, have been back the best. To you. You have been the best. Thank you so much for everything you have done. And it's been an incredible 6 years. I've had a wonderful time on Wake Up With Al.
Me too.
Let's take a look back at what we did. And good morning, everybody. Thank you for waking up with me. I'm Al Roker.
I gotta say, it's always great waking up with you, Regis.
Oh, Steph-o.
The wind chills are going to be a huge factor today.
The good news is it has picked up in speed, so right. It is moving faster.
I always say the atmosphere is like a hamburger. Look at the tornado track. You can actually see it on satellite. It looks like a war zone here.
We are talking about a monster storm. It's the worst ice situation in 5 years along the river. There was a lot more of this beach. It is now eroded.
You're much more nicer to hold on to than that fire hydrant over there. I just want to state that.
I'm meteorologist Stephanie Abram, live here in just north of Birmingham, Alabama. Listen, you can't hump me on TV.
That just shows you how...
Oh, I'm sorry. Oh,
no. Sorry about the suit.
Our hurricane specialist, Carl Parker.
No,
why? Why? Because we can.
It really, all I can taste is the,
You're a very pretty lady. Well, we want to thank the crew because it has been just, they've made it possible.
We might be the faces of the show, but there are a lot of really hardworking people that wake up at midnight to come in to get the show prepped and ready to get on air. So we couldn't have done it without all of you and, of course, all of you at home. Thank you from the bottom of our heart. It was an honor, privilege, and I will cherish every moment for the rest of my life.
Well, the good news is you're going to keep on keeping on the Weather Channel.
Yes.
And we'll announce that. And we're starting a digital morning show called The Lift. It'll be starting in a few weeks. Mm-hmm. And there's good things coming, but... Always. I would not trade this 6 years for anything in the world.
I wouldn't either. I love you.
Love you too. We're back after your local events.
Freshen up your fall wardrobe with head-to-toe savings. Right now at Men's Warehouse, select suits are only $199.99. All shoes are 30% off. Plus, buy one, get one free on even more of your fall favorites. Men's Warehouse. Follow your style.
Take Zequal and sleep like the kids went to Nana's house. For the whole weekend. ZzzQuil, the non-habit-forming sleep aid that helps you sleep easily and wake refreshed. Because sleep is a beautiful thing.
Hello?
It's Dr. Moreno's office. Can you come in to talk about your biopsy results and bring someone with you?
Sign up for The Walk and raise money so no one has to walk alone.
What do you think?
Good morning.
In the park.
Attention shoppers, there's a lost couple in the men's department.
There's a great big unkhaki world out there. Explore it in a Subaru Crosstrek. Look, it's what makes a Subaru a Subaru.
When is your flu shot more than a flu shot? When it helps give a life-saving vaccine to a child in need in a developing country. Thanks to customers like you, Walgreens Get a Shot, Give a Shot program has helped provide 7 million vaccines. Make your flu shot make a world of difference. Walgreens, at the corner of happy and healthy.
to make sure everybody can get an idea of what's happening here.
Let's talk about that.
Let's lift the base of this.
You're about to see something you have never seen on television.
I just had a horrible nightmare. My company's entire network went down and I was home in bed unaware. But that would never happen. Comcast Business monitors my company's network 24 hours a day and calls and emails me of something like, this scary storm takes it offline, so I can rest easy. What, you don't have a desk bed?
Don't be left in the dark. Get proactive alerts 24/7. Comcast Business, built for business.
Feel secure in your dentures. Feel free to be yourself all day. Just switch from denture paste to C-Bond denture adhesive seals. Hold stronger than the leading paste all day without the ooze. Feel secure. Be yourself with stronger, clean C-Bond.
One day, it appears.
Is that a dark spot?
New Gold Bond Dark Spot Minimizing Cream for Body. Targeted to help fade the look of dark spots beginning in 4 weeks. New Gold Bond for Dark Spots in the body lotion aisle.
Go!
Run like an eagle!
Who said science isn't fun?
Three scientists walk into a bar. Bottoms Up, October 4th on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under fair skies. Today, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 89. Chance of rain 40%. Tonight, considerable cloudiness. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 72. Saturday, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 88. Winds west at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Almost 50 minutes past the hour, and Jen Carfagno, you have been as much part of this program as anybody. Thank you so much for everything you did. I know you've got a lot more going on at the Weather Channel after we go off the air, but again, thank you for all you've done for us, and now you got the tropical update.
Oh, we got that. We got a lot here, but just what a ride it has been right here. What a great honor it's been to be a part of this show. And, you know, we spend every day making sure you have what you need to get out the door. I want to make sure you have the tropics because it's very important what we're watching with Joaquin. Hurricane Joaquin, 130 miles per hour, category 4. I mean, a category 4 hurricane has been sitting here now for more than a day, lashing the central Bahamas. And we've been watching very closely potential impacts on the eastern seaboard. And while it may not be direct, and I'll show you that cone, there will be a connected link to Joaquin and the rainfall and the wind that we're going to get on the eastern seaboard over the weekend. So I'll show you that in a moment. But let's look at this new projected path. If you've been following this, and if you're just tuning in for the first time this morning, we now have it completely offshore in the projected path in terms of the cone and the center of circulation. Finally, the GFS, the American model, has made the same turn that the European model has been hanging on to now since the beginning, keeping it offshore. And you can see they're not exactly one-to-one on top of each other in terms of the position, but they are very close, and they are both, most importantly, offshore of the U.S. eastern seaboard. Now, that said, there is a link. There is a tropical link to the moisture that we are going to get here across South and North Carolina. Your heavy rain is already in the forecast. Big upper level low, old front that sort of died out across the area. Yeah, there's a lot of reasons why we're going to get heavy rain in South and North Carolina, but also related to this is the fact that you'll see a connection. Look at this. This is the forecast, future radar, a connection between that rain and Joaquin. And this is Friday, and we got heavy rain in Charleston continuing into overnight Saturday, Saturday morning, North Carolina, Virginia, places that saw some of their record wettest days on record this past week. We'll be getting more rain this weekend, and it continues the link. Here's Joaquin out here, and you see that tropical moisture link all the way through the weekend to that rainfall across the Mid-Atlantic and the Southeast. More than a foot of rain is possible. We're very concerned about flooding, river flooding, stream flooding, flash flooding. We're also concerned about the onshore flow, and we're going to see that continuing to raise the concern of coastal flooding. You know, last weekend, the supermoon and the onshore flow caused some big problems. We're going to watch watch that again, especially at times of high tide. And then just the fact that it's going to be miserable to be outside. It's going to be chilly and rainy and very windy. This is the wind forecast, and Steph, winds over 25 to 30 miles per hour right through the weekend. All right, Steph, I'll send it back to you.
Jen, thanks so much. Well, this is it. We're going to wrap up the final show of Wake Up with Al just ahead here on the Weather Channel. We're going to have a closer look at the heavy rain and the college football forecast as well.
A gentleman is never defined by just one look. Get more looks for less at the Joseph A. Bank Buy More, Save More event. Buy one item, save 50%. Two items, save 60%. And three items, save 65%. Only at Joseph A. Bank.
If you have moderate to severe plaque psoriasis, isn't it time to let the real you shine through? Introducing Otezla, apremilast. Otezla is not an injection or a cream. It's a pill that treats plaque psoriasis differently. Some people who took Otezla saw 75% clearer skin after 4 months. And Otezla's prescribing information has no requirement for routine lab monitoring. Don't take Otezla if you are allergic to any of its ingredients. Otezla may increase the risk of depression. Tell your doctor if you have a history of depression or suicidal thoughts, or if these feelings develop. Some people taking Otezla reported weight loss. Your doctor should monitor your weight and may stop treatment. Side effects may include diarrhea, nausea, upper respiratory tract infection, and headache. Tell your doctor about all the medicines you take and if you're pregnant or planning to be. Ask your doctor about Otezla today. Otezla. Show more of you.
Meet Kyle. You name it. Dust, pollen,
and pet dandruff.
He's allergic to it.
Stanley Steamer is the first carpet cleaning service to be certified asthma and allergy friendly, eliminating an average of 94% of common household allergens like dust, pollen, and pet dander for a cleaner, healthier home.
Goodbye, Mr. Steamer.
Bye, Kyle.
Call now about our $99 carpet cleaning special.
Call 1-800-STEAMER. Stanley Steamer, your certified cleaner.
I take Prilosec OTC each morning for my frequent heartburn. Because you can't beat zero heartburn. Ah, the sweet taste of it.
Prilosec OTC. One pill each morning, 24 hours, zero heartburn.
That was unexpected. But you always know exactly what to expect when you have Amica Auto Insurance.
Personal attention and great service every time you call.
Call for a free quote now. You can save up to 15% when you combine auto and home insurance with Amica. Remember, the unexpected can always happen. So call Amica and expect great service every time.
Very intense right now.
Oh my God.
That's blacked out.
This is so cool.
All right, we kick off your day with a beautiful sunrise out here. Detroit, you see a nice glow of orange in the sky, although definitely has the look to a cool-looking sky out there in terms of temperatures, right? That is a fall sky. Temperatures in the 40s this morning. Topping out near 60 this afternoon. Kids get off the bus, say they can shed that jacket, but they will need it this morning. All right, let's go south. It is rainy and chilly across the southeast. Temperatures in the 50s to start in Raleigh, North Carolina. Kids need the rain boots, the jacket, the umbrella, and then they'll still need it when they get off the bus. Boston also cooler than it has been lately. Temperatures only in the 50s. The weather really starts to go downhill later today with more rain and more wind when they get off the bus. All right, let's talk about Atlanta. We also have more showers in the area. Should be dry at the bus stop, although can't rule out a little bit of drizzle. And then later today when the kids get off the bus. This afternoon is going to be hard to get those soccer practices in again with the rainfall. Speaking of practices and games, let's talk sports and take a live look at Clemson campus in South Carolina. Hosted Notre Dame this weekend, looking for a lot of rain to come in and affect the game. All right, Al and Steph, back to you.
Jen, thank you so much, and I want to thank you so much because this has been an absolute joy for the last 6 years.
Agreed. You personify generosity and grace and compassion, and we're all better because we were able to work with you.
Because we were a team. And
yeah, it's a team.
Vinny, widen that out, would you? And that camera out, Vinny, widen out. Just rock it out. Everybody come on in here. Yeah. Everybody come on in.
And by the way, Al, here's a little something.
Oh, well, I've got a little something
on behalf of all of us. Thank you. And thank you,
guys.
Everybody.
Susan Swenson, this was the woman who created the show.
The OG right here.
That's right. Thank you. This has been such a joy. We've had such a good time. And for our friends in Atlanta, hopefully you get a shot of everybody there as well, because this has been an amazing bi-city team effort. I am just so, so proud of all of everything we've done over these last 6 years.
Thank you for being our fearless leader.
Oh, please. Thank you. Hey, everybody have a great time. Survive Joaquin. And thank you for the last 6 years.
Big kiss, everybody. All of us, right? We got to dance, right?
Currently in our area, 76 degrees under fair skies. Today, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 89. Chance of rain 40%. Tonight, considerable cloudiness. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 72. Saturday, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 88. Winds west at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Friday morning, and we have a Cat 4 hurricane off the east coast of the U.S. still this morning with high sustained winds 130 miles an hour. Let's get you ready for your weekend. We'll make it amazing. We're live from here in Seaside Heights, New Jersey, where the waves and the onshore flow of water are considered to be a problem all weekend long, all the way down the coastline to flooding rains in Charleston, and also the real coastal issues that'll be in the southeast and the flooding rain that'll be in many of the mid-Atlantic states. We've got it all covered. AMHQ is covering this tropical system the way only the Weather Channel can. Storm tracker Jim Cantore is in Charleston, South Carolina this morning. Mike Seidel is actually live in Virginia Beach, so we've got all the beach areas covered this morning. Joaquin is making a slight turn out to sea overnight, but still, most cases you could breathe a sigh of relief when a storm like this is passing offshore, but you cannot do it with this one. 46 million Americans are under the threat of coastal flooding and real flooding this morning. Let's start with Jim. Good morning, Jim.
Yeah, good morning, Sam. Some pretty strong wording out of the Weather Service offices in Western South Carolina, Greenville, Spartanburg, to be specific, Columbia as well, and Charleston, South Carolina, talking about what could be a historic event here in the state, which is why we are certainly here and going to cover this for you. We have a lot going on. It is now getting into Friday. People are making weekend plans to either come to Charleston or come to the upstate. Huge game in Clemson we have to watch, because as this event is unfolding, people will be on the roads. Some of these roads may be washed out. Some of these roads may be tree covered or power line covered as we go on in time. So let's get into this. All right. The pregame is just as important as what is going to happen, because we've absolutely saturated all of the watersheds in the upstate of South Carolina, northeast Georgia, western North Carolina, and even southwest Virginia. If you look at the stream flow gauges this morning, everybody is at 90% full or higher. So there's no place for heavy rain to go. Water vapor tells the tale really nice. Big upper low working its way over Alabama this morning. Of course, you've got the hurricane down to the south, where we will have a moisture tap coming in. But right now, notice the difference between the outflow, the air that's going around the upper low and the air that's going around the outflow of the hurricane. That diffluent area, that area where it splits, is a very favorable area for rising air motion. All right. We also have coastal convergence going on with the front. So there is plenty of ways to lift this tremendously saturated air mass, this deep tropical air mass, and rain it out as we go through the next 72 hours over South Carolina, over northeast Georgia, eastern Tennessee, eastern Kentucky, western Virginia. west central North Carolina, even eastern North Carolina. So this morning, most of our rain shifting up to the north a little bit, at least for the time being. Myrtle Beach, Wilmington's getting soaked. Raleigh's getting soaked. We've already got rain as well in the upstate. So that is already an upslope component that's developed, even though we haven't even got into the main event yet. So we're continuing to keep things saturated. The moisture tap, you can see it right here. That very high available moisture area, obviously, is with a hurricane. We know we have many miles up in the atmosphere of moisture in through here, and you can see clearly that tap that is going to be available for this event on that precipitable water. Here's the RPM. Here's a look at the model going forward. Again, getting into the overnight hours, just past high tide here, by the way, which we have to watch in Charleston because that's when we will have our worst flooding. You can see the rain that just sits over Charleston, sits over Columbia, sits over Asheville, over Greenville, Spartanburg, over Greer, South Carolina. All these areas have to pay attention going right through Sunday. Rains as well heading up into toward Virginia as well. And it won't take much. Even though we may not have as much forecast for western North and South Carolina, it doesn't matter because you have the topography issues. The topography issues there, guys, are going to play a key role in this. If you are going to the Clemson game on Saturday, again, pay attention to your routes, know where you're going, and realize that when you get to the game, the route that you took to get there may not be open on the way back, especially if it is pouring down rain. All right, let's talk about Joaquin this morning. And again, our hearts going out to the people in the central and southern Bahamas, Jen. I can't believe what I see. The western eye wall just hammering Long Island this morning.
I mean, it's been raking Long Island in the central Bahamas now for more than 24 hours. We've been dealing with this system right overhead, and it is still very powerful. In fact, it has strengthened. It's a category 4. This time yesterday was not that strong, but it is a category 4, right here as of the 5 o'clock advisory. All right, so winds 130 miles per hour, 935 millibar pressure. The plane is out and flying into it, and we'll get some new data soon from the hurricane hunters as to what the latest on the wind and pressure is. But, you know, there certainly are signs that it is still very, very powerful. Hurricane warnings are up. Tropical storm warnings are up. Hurricane watch is up. That's not changing for the Bahamas. For the U.S. East Coast, there are no watches and warnings with regard to the hurricane. Now, here is a closer view of the satellite. And again, you can see Crooked Island, Long Island, right here in the central Bahamas, just continuing to get pounded. Now, I've seen a lot of pictures of flooding. I haven't seen a lot of wind damage pictures, not yet, not to say that it hasn't happened, just haven't, the data hasn't really gotten to us as well. We can take you out to Exuma and Calypso Beach, and or Hopetown Beach, and show you what it looks like out there. So you can see the palm trees blowing in the wind. Again, you can see the rain on the lens of the camera as well. You know, I want to take into the satellite overlaid with some of the OBS that we have. Yonder, over yonder key, gust to 31 miles per hour. By the way, Nassau is up here, and amazingly, with the fact that it's Joaquin has stayed right where it has for so long, Nassau actually has been spared some of the worst of it so far. Now, the turn that's making right now to the northwest, very slowly, but then the turn it's going to make to the north will bring improving weather, Sam, to the Bahamas by later tonight and tomorrow, but we still have today to get through and still dealing with some very difficult weather right here in the Bahamas. Meanwhile, Sam, you know, that the pressure gradient between what's happening in the Atlantic and that high to the north is just creating a lot of wind all the way up the eastern seaboard.
Yeah. Exactly, Jen, and that's been the biggest problem here overnight in Seaside Heights, New Jersey, all the way toward Long Island as well. It's that focused wind. We had steady winds at about 30 miles an hour. We have a high wind warning in this area. Gusts could be as high as 50 or 60 miles an hour in the central and southern Jersey Shore area. And at every high tide cycle, there will be extra water along the coastline pushed in, and it may not be able to get out. So that's why they're concerned about a lot of coastal flooding from here all the way toward Virginia and North Carolina. You can see behind me some of the berm that they put up on the beach. They just pulled some of the heavy equipment out, but let's get to the forecast because a lot of folks in the Northeast are wondering how close this system will get to them. We know we got the winds, Jen, because we're in between those two systems. What else do we get?
Yeah, we're going to be looking at the winds, and we're also going to be dealing with some rain coming through, but as we show you, as we go through the next 24 hours, everybody's going to be really feeling the effects of those winds, as Jen just mentioned, the high to the north, and of course, our Hurricane Joaquin. As we show you a live view of New Jersey, Atlantic City. Notice it's really quiet, but let's move that ahead and we want to show you what's happening on the radar. The rain is moving in for Norfolk as well as into Washington, D.C. So far, you're dealing with the light stuff, but this is going up and down Interstate 95. Now, we want to talk more about the rain and kind of time it out for you because as we go through the afternoon, yes, you're going to be looking at showers. As you drive home, more of that rain coming through. This is going to stop you at 6 o'clock. And then we go late tonight into the overnight hours. Notice some of that heavier rainfall working into the western parts of the mountains. Worried there because potentially could be looking at some problems with some flooding. Nighttime, can't see what's happening. And this whole area has already been inundated with heavy rainfall just really over the last 7 days. As we take you through tomorrow, notice in the evening hours, we'll be looking at some scattered showers. As we go through Sunday, here are our amounts. Roanoke, 3 to 5. The same for Richmond down towards Danville. Even into Washington, D.C., you're going to be on that very tight line. As we go through Sunday, we'll look at those wind gusts, even up to about 35 to 60 miles per hour. Right now, we're going to turn over to Mike Seidel, who's live in Virginia Beach.
And good morning, guys, from here on the beach. You can see the surf is up. There goes the sea foam, another high tide at noon. We'll come back here on MHQ and show you how much more sand we've lost. What a visual in about 5 minutes and continuing coverage up and down the coast throughout the morning here on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 76 degrees under fair skies. Today, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 89. Chance of rain 40%. Tonight, considerable cloudiness. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 72. Saturday, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 88. Here's our 7-day outlook.
And good morning, everyone, from the historic Battery here in Charleston, South Carolina, as we continue to see the East Coast get pounded here. And yes, we are not going to see Joaquin come onshore, or landfall, as we call it, but we are going to see a tremendous gradient between the high to the north, which is even stronger than last week's, and the low, obviously, with Joaquin. And that is going to set us up again for another pounding on the beaches. And speaking of getting pounded this morning, let's take you to Virginia Beach. Mike Seidel getting hammered in Virginia Beach. Mike, it's raining hard, but it's cold, isn't it?
Well, actually, Jim, not right here. We're around 70, but you just go inland towards Richmond, and it's in the mid-50s. So we're fortunate that we're in that last little bit of tropical air. And you mentioned about the tides and the erosion. Boy, and the winds, they are higher than last week. We've already gusted close to 40 miles an hour. That's higher than we had last week when we had the 5 days of unrelenting. Here comes the surf. Look at the sea foam. And we're still now about 5 hours. We've got almost a whole morning to get to high tide around lunchtime. And look at this cut, Jim. I mean, well, you've seen places where you have to climb ladders in the past, but this is about a 4-foot cut on this beach. Yesterday it was about here. And as the water comes in, it'll just eat away. It'll just churn away this beach. There's the dune line up here. So from the edge of this cliff, the erosion to the fence, that's about 12 to 15 feet. That's it. Take a look at the surf this morning. It is breaking as far as the eye can see, way, way out there. These are 6 to 8 footers. The buoys offshore, now south of Cape May, New Jersey, as high as 17 feet. Coastal flood warnings widespread from the Jersey Shore, where Sam is, all the way down to Morehead City, North Carolina. That includes the Outer Banks. Also, those precocious Maryland, Delaware beaches, Bethany, Rehoboth, Dewey, Ocean City, Maryland. They're going to lose certainly a lot of sand. That's going to be the big story because with 40-mile-an-hour wind gusts, that's really not going to cause any issues with structural damage. But it's just continuous pounding of these beaches, Jim, these waves, the tides, and especially through Saturday night. Now, as we get into Sunday, we'll start to see things backing off with the gradient, but it won't be till Monday till the hurricane Joaquin passes us by at our latitude, fortunately well off the coast. But we're going to be out here, Jim, watching the beach go away. That's the saddest part of this whole story here. And also down in your area, we're going to have those tremendous amounts of rainfall. Right now, we're forecasting 1 to 3 inches of rain here, Jim, in the Tidewater, maybe a few higher totals. But really, the boatload of rain will be down towards where you are in Charleston, South Carolina, where you have the issue with the high tide and the rainfall on those streets there in that beautiful city.
That's exactly right. And that's exactly our biggest concern, Mike, without a doubt. We even had some flooding around here yesterday. And Mike kind of nailed it. I mean, the two issues that we're dealing with in the east are the waves and the tremendous beach setup and erosion that we're going to deal with. And then across the southeast and the lowlands all the way up to the upstate, the tremendous potential for historic flooding as well, especially at the time of high tide. You see the 12 to 18 inches forecast for Charleston, for Columbia, South Carolina. We will break out of this drought. The problem is we've already done that in the upstate, especially with the stream flows as high as they are. All right, let's go ahead and talk a little bit about the flooding and take a look at some of your social pictures this morning. Anna Rodas Rodriguez joins us back in the studios, Atlantic. Good morning, A-Rod.
Good morning, Jim, and good morning to you at home. We know that the Caribbean Emergency Management Agency has activated their emergency ops department. If we can show you what Joaquin has done already in the Bahamas, look at all of this water encroaching into homes. We know that public offices are closed, schools are closed, airports are closed, and people who live in low-lying areas like this have been asked to evacuate. They have a whole regional support team trying to help them deal with the possibility of destruction and devastation, the aftermath of devastating flooding. Let's head to South Carolina, a place that's under the gun for possibly more flooding, and they don't need it. Look at the coastal flooding that's already happening in Charleston. We have every county in South and North Carolina under a flash flood watch today and for the coming days. We head to New Jersey. They're getting ready. Of course, memories of Sandy, still very fresh for a lot of people who lost a lot. Look at these military-grade equipments, front loaders, pushing sand and making it into berms, berms that could be as high as 10 feet, completely hugging the entire coastline as they prepare for possible coastal flooding. Jen, keep sending us those pictures. Use the hashtag MyWeather. Back to you.
All right, I'll take it from there. And we want to talk more about the impacts of Hurricane Joaquin on Florida. When you hear about a major hurricane, you automatically think, well, Florida's got to be in play. Well, in fact, it is now. We want to take you and show you exactly Hurricane Joaquin. You already know it's across central parts of Bahamas. Category 4, too close for comfort for you in Florida. But we want to show you just how close it is. If we pull the arrow out, it's roughly about 370 miles away. It's moved about 100 miles to the west since this time yesterday. But what are your impacts going to be? Well, luckily, we're going to continue finally to see Hurricane Joaquin moving up towards the northeast. And here's why, because the jet stream is basically going to push Joaquin out of the way. But you are going to see some of the impacts as we go through the next 24 hours. Notice all up and down Florida, high risk for rip current. So this is not a day that you go out for the beach and try to capture some of the images outside, because it's going to be way too dangerous right along the coastline. Right now, we're going to send it over to you, who's live in Virginia Beach. No, Charleston. Jim Cantori.
All right, thanks, Jen. Yeah, guys, we're going to leave you with this right now. I want to show you the high tide cycles here in Charleston, because it is a combination of that heavy rainfall and the high tides that puts Charleston at risk. I mean, remember, we're talking about 10 to 15 inches of rain forecast here. If that heavy rain is during the time of high tides, and you see them right here, this city will flood. We'll be right back.
If you have moderate to severe rheumatoid arthritis like me, and you're talking to a rheumatologist about a biologic, this is Humira. This is Humira, helping to relieve my pain and protect my joints from further damage. This is Humira, helping me reach for more. Doctors have been prescribing Humira for more than 10 years. Humira works for many adults. It targets and helps to block a specific source of inflammation that contributes to RA symptoms.
Humira can lower your ability to fight infections, including tuberculosis. Serious, sometimes fatal infections and cancers, including lymphoma, have happened, as have blood, liver, and nervous system problems, serious allergic reactions, and new or worsening heart failure. Before treatment, get tested for TB. Tell your doctor if you've been to areas where certain fungal infections are common, and if you've had TB, hepatitis B, are prone to infections, or have flu-like symptoms or sores. Don't start Humira if you have an infection.
Talk to your doctor and visit Humira.com. This is Humira at work.
I don't know what that was.
It felt huge.
Don't move, man.
I just had a horrible nightmare. My company's entire network went down and I was home in bed unaware. But that would never happen. Comcast Business monitors my company's network 24 hours a day and calls and emails me of something like, this scary storm takes it offline, so I can rest easy. What, you don't have a desk bed?
Don't be left in the dark. Get proactive alerts 24/7. Comcast Business, built for business.
You know me as Nota Begay III, golf analyst for NBC Sports and Golf Channels and founder of the MB3 Foundation. But my favorite title is Champion for Kids Health. I'm living my dream and I want to make that possible for all children. We must give kids what they need to become teachers, artists, doctors, even golfers. But dreams can get lost if our kids aren't healthy. And right now in our country, 1 in 3 kids are obese. We must do better. Join me. Help all kids live healthy now so they can build healthy futures.
Go!
Run like an eagle!
Who said science isn't fun?
Three scientists walk into a bar. Bottoms up October 4th on the Weather Channel.
Stay tuned for your local on the 8, brought to you by Valero.
We've worked pretty hard to become the world's largest independent refiner and to be America's third largest producer of renewable fuels. But we've also worked hard to be named one of Fortune's most admired companies by giving over 125,000 volunteer hours a year, donating over 1 million pounds of food to local food banks, and building homes for Habitat for Humanity. To appreciate a company's true value, you have to understand the heart of its people.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under fair skies.
Today, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 89. Chance of rain 40%. Tonight, considerable cloudiness. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 72. Saturday, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 88. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Minutes after the hour right here on AMHQ. Just want to show you the entire east coast of the U.S. is kind of watching a big combination of weather patterns this morning, from Hurricane Joaquin in the Bahamas to a large area of high pressure that is just to the north of the U.S. border. So we're watching all this wind push in. We're in Seaside Heights, New Jersey, and I just wanted to show you this morning the wave heights out here anywhere from 7 to 12 feet. There's some estimates they could be as high as 20 feet later today. You can see some berming around some key intersections here around Seaside Heights. And you can also see the tracks where the heavy equipment was out all night long. Winds here, high wind warning later on today, Central Jersey, South Jersey shoreline. Coastal flood warnings as well for this area. And every inch of the coastline is watching as Joaquin does a drive-by in the East Coast. Normally, you would give an all clear and a sigh of relief as a hurricane doesn't make any connection with the East Coast of the U.S. But in this case, we're not going to be able to do that. And we've got problems with it all the way through Sunday. From the very heavy rain in the Carolinas, the catastrophic flooding that's possible with this heavy rain in that area, to every coastal community in the U.S. watching every inch of this water move close. We've got high tide problems all the way through Sunday. The problem and the worry here is that coastal communities will not be able to get the water out when it moves in. Let's show you some of the coastal areas that we're watching this morning. We'll start with Myrtle Beach, I believe, and we've got about more than 750 miles of the U.S. coastline in the line of fire. Flood watch for Myrtle Beach continuing through the weekend. Expect the heavy rain and breezy conditions there. And let's head up into Portland, Maine, because you won't believe that even Maine, the Maine coast, is concerned about this. There's particular problems of coastal flooding and beach erosion in those areas as well. Let's talk about the heavy rain and flooding. That is a large band of rain getting pushed onto the Carolina shoreline, and it may be there for a few days. Jim Cantore is beneath some of that this morning. Brent. Good morning, Jim.
Hey, good morning, Sam. Yeah, we're on the Battery here in Charleston, the historic Battery. Battles, hurricanes, we've had it all in through here. And, of course, we're awaiting what could be just a tremendous event. All week we've been watching the models, 15 inches, 10 inches, 12 inches of rain printing out in Charleston. And now, again, it looks like it's going to be a believable situation. And really the key for this area is when is that rain going to occur? If it's about 2 hours before and after high tide, we got big problems here. There's very little room for error. Tides are already high. They're about 2 feet above mean tide. So, you know, you don't have a good way to get that water out if it's already high in the first place. So that is going to be a key component of what eventually happens to Charleston in the end. All right, let's get into what is going on with Joaquin, a Category 4 hurricane. Of course, it's amazing. We go the whole hurricane season here, and we have to wait for the monster. Very, very low pressures, historic low pressures in the Bahamas for this time of the year, that's for sure. Northwest at 3 miles per hour here. Again, it's just jogging, but thank goodness it's starting to move to the north a little bit. Unfortunately, it has been sitting and pounding places like Crooked Island, Long Island as well. Nassau, you're not doing too bad. It's kind of amazing. You got a 130-mile-an-hour hurricane just a little bit off to your east, and you're not doing too bad, but believe me,